veteran Roger Staubach, number 12, will be the quarterback for the Dallas Cowboys. And for the New York Giants, also number 12, the rookie from Northern Illinois, Jerry Goldstein. We're at Texas Stadium in the city of Irving, between Dallas and Fort Worth, and a sellout crowd fills this magnificent structure for the game between the Dallas Cowboys and the New York Giants. And good afternoon, I'm Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire. And I hate to start on a negative aspect, but the hot weather is going to be a factor here in this contest this afternoon.
And the Giant bench is in the sunlight, but Andy Robustelli, the Giant GM, said that the sun does move, so maybe they'll score late.
I knew he'd know something like that. Realistically, Tom, what do you think of the Giants' chances?
Well, Goldstein, a rookie quarterback, is not easy for the rest of the team. I do think they have to go outside to Moorhead and Robinson early to stretch out that that good Dallas defense. And Zonka, if he's the same Zonka that intimidated before, they can keep him inside on a pretty honest basis.
A lot of people have wondered about the whereabouts of last year's Heisman Trophy winner, Tony Dorsett. And the reason he's on the bench is another very good athlete.
Well, Preston Pearson just did such a fantastic job and actually beat Dorsett out during the training camp, so they said the best player should win, and that's the way the Dallas team is. And Pat, I really don't think that Dallas knows how good a football team they are yet.
All right, Tom, let's get down and pick up what's going on that hot field this afternoon. The Giants have won the toss. They will receive the kickoff. Fryn Herrera, number one for the Dallas Cowboys, you see right there, will kick it off. And throughout the afternoon, you'll see those shadows creeping across the field, and as Andy Robustelli said to Tom Brookshire just before, the sun does move, and that spot's going to be moving throughout the day. It obviously causes us some problems with our camera going from the shade to the sun like that, and it causes the players problems too. Gordon Bell and Bobby Hammond are deep for the Giants, and this is a Fryn Herrera starting his trot for the kickoff. It'll be Hammond at the two. About the 30, good return for Bobby Hammond. They got the wedge in front, and they got it moving. Here's the offensive line for the Giants now.
And it's a pretty active one. Gravel, Van Horn now moved to guard where he plays much better. Hill, the fugitive from the WFL, playing pretty good center. Big John Hicks at right guard, and of course, Mullen now moved to right tackle.
The receivers, Jimmy Robinson and Moorhead, wide, and Bob Tucker, the tight end. That's the backfield. Goldstein, the quarterback. Doug Coder, number 44, and Larry Zonka. Zonka, of course, is 39. It's first down Giants at their own 30-yard line. First offensive play for Goldstein. He fakes to Coder and fires to the outside, intended for Robinson. Benny Barnes was close to him. Dealing from the sun into the shadows, and that is the young man from Northern Illinois who missed last year because of a bad knee.
He's big, though, at 6'4". Here's that defense. That's Too Tall Jones, Jethro Pugh, of course, Randy White, the rhinoceros at right tackle, and playing very well, and big Harvey Martin, who turned him on last week.
The linebackers, Henderson, Brunig, and Dee Lewis. And the secondary, Barnes, Aaron Kyle, Charlie Waters, and Cliff Harris.
And that's as good as there is in that secondary, maybe.
That might be as good a defensive unit as there is. On second down, Doug Coder runs into some of that defense and does not quite get back to the line of scrimmage. The whole front four, the ones we just named.
Pugh and White in particular, the two tackles, pinched it off. Here is where the Giants must make the Dallas team play honest. Now, Zonka takes the fake. Good blocker, by the way, Zonka. And Coder is one of the sneaky running backs around, underrated, and a pretty good inside runner, but no chance there.
Jethro Pugh was the first big guy to wrap his arms around Doug Coder. Third down and exactly 10 still. Giants at their own 30. Goldstein on a long count. It might have worked. He ran the draw play to Zonka, but Ed Jones jumped off sides and could not get back. It'll be called encroachment. The referee is Gordon McCarter. You'll be hearing his voice in just a few minutes. The umpire is Paul Trapinski. Head linesman Jerry Seaman. Line judge Nathan Jones. Here we go. Back judge is Ray Douglas. The field judge is Armin Terzian.
It's hard to hide, 6'9". Too Tall had no chance to get lost. Couldn't even go under the rug.
Offside, number 72, defense, third down.
Gordon McCarter confirms that it was Ed Jones that was offsides. It'll be second and third and five, Megan.
Three,
Coder coming wide. Charlie Waters is the first man out there, helped by Aaron Kyle, the second-year cornerback who's played so well in place of Mel Renfro.
Heck of a defensive play by Kyle, because actually the good block by Zonko and the linebacker, Henderson, made that play look like it was going to get the first down.
It'll be fourth and five at our first look at Dave Jennings. Butch Johnson is number 86 in the middle of your picture right now. Back alone for Dallas, a dangerous punt returner.
Let's see if they put pressure on Jennings.
They do not. They're trying to set up a return.
Ooh.
Oh, beautiful punt by Jennings. Butch Johnson fields at the 20. Breaks one tackle. Breaks another. Gets to the 26. And the Dallas offensive unit trots on the field, headed by Roger Staubach. We'll take a look at that offense, which has been sort of rebuilt. Pat Donovan has replaced Rayfield Wright at right tackle. Tom Rafferty has replaced Blaine Nye at right guard. John Fitzgerald still the center. Herbert Scott and Ralph Neely, the veteran left tackle. Those are the receivers. Richards, Pearson, Dupree, the back Staubach, Preston Pearson, and Robert Newhouse. First down, Dallas. First and 10. Ball is at their own 27-yard line. Dupree came in motion. The pitch back is to Newhouse. Newhouse still on his feet for about eight. Newhouse all the way out to the 35.
That time they ran right at Jeter, the big rookie from USC. He's number 70 to the bottom of your screen, and they'll straighten him up. Donovan is a very good offensive tackle. Once they got the defensive end moving back, here he comes back in to help on the play. But Newhouse, again, can hide behind his own blockers, and it's darn hard to seek him out.
That time he was right behind his off-guard, Herbert Scott, that he bowled in underneath. So it'll be second and two for Dallas at their own 35. Roger Staubach, the quarterback. Newhouse again. Newhouse close to first down.
Jack Gregory made the tackle. Let's go over that defensive giant front four. It's Jeter at left end. Mendenhall, of course, at the nose, are the left tackle. Big Troy Archer, the kid from Colorado, who is one of the fast becoming one of the fine inside rushers in football. And Gregory at the right defensive end. Van Pelt, Carson, Brian Kelly, a tackling bunch of linebackers. And there's your new secondary.
It is first down, Dallas. Somebody's going to go in motion. They're not going to run from that formation. You know, it's Drew Pearson. Now it's Preston Pearson, and Brad Van Pelt is the first guy to make contact, and he closed in a hurry.
I tell you, he is really a load. And of course, oh, there's Tom Landry, by the way, sitting in Butch Johnson with the play. We watched Landry last week under trying conditions in their tough game with the Minnesota Vikings. And I'll be darned if I saw any change in expression on Tom Landry, whether they were ahead or behind or almost losing it.
Even when Staubach went in on the plunge on overtime and won it, there was still no change. Of course, there was no change on the face of Bud Grant either. Second and seven for Dallas, and Staubach fakes the draw to Newhouse. Throws. Dupree had it and lost it. Clyde Powers was the defender.
Super play. They almost had solo coverage, and that's just a tight end on a square outside maneuver. And there's nobody to get help from when you're solo, and Powers has always been pretty good at the solo type coverage.
So it'll be third and seven for Dallas. They beat Minnesota last week in overtime, 16-10. And the Giants upset Washington, 20-17.
Let's see if the Giants have a little bit of a pass rush. That might have an indication for us as to what the game's going to boil down to.
Staubach now operating from the shotgun, the deep formation. Dupree ships back inside. Long count. Good snap. No, not much rush. Here comes Archer, and down goes Staubach. Troy Archer, who doesn't know how good he can be.
Jack Gregory says that number 77 right now doesn't even know where to go, and he's one of the best defensive tackles in football. The big kid from Colorado and Gregory's roommate. Now watch him keep coming. He tries to spin to the lower part of your screen, and now Roger tries to run, and we know what he can do with it. Archer is really a bear.
Tom, I guess the coverage must have been pretty good, too. Back deep for the Giants is Bobby Hammond, number 33, and to punt for Dallas is Danny White, number 11. Fine kick. Chases Hammond back to the 17. Trying to get across the field, can go nowhere. Randy Hughes, the guy who put the hand on him. And there, Tom, is another good athlete who can't get into the lineup.
Yeah, Randy just keeps waiting for somebody to get too old, and they're all too young.
Giants nothing, Dallas nothing.
Like I tell my friends, I said, see a Firestone deal if you're having trouble with all your ties.
Ask a friend about Firestone, Firestone, Firestone.
When you're driving on a Firestone tire, it's a good feeling.
You and I, when we go to buy a tire, I don't believe we're experts. You need somebody to explain to you. That's why I feel I can depend on Firestone. I don't feel that they've ever let me down.
Firestone.
Some people think all color TVs are pretty much the same. I'm a TV service technician, and I say bunk.
In a nationwide survey, independent TV service technicians gave their opinion of color TVs. They picked one brand, more than any other, for highest quality and for fewest repairs. One brand, Zenith, for the sixth straight year.
Zenith says the quality goes in before the name goes on. And you know what? It really does.
Giants ball on their own 22. First and 10. Those Dallas cheerleaders have become almost as much of a famous part of this stadium and this football team as the football team itself.
I can't argue with that.
I didn't expect you would. First and 10. Jerry Goldstein, the Giant quarterback. Larry Zonka, the Giant fullback, with not much doing. D.D. Lewis and four or five more. D.D. Lewis, number 50, led the charge against Zonka.
The Giants do not have a lot of great speed to the outside. Coder is a lot quicker than people think, but it's not a game breaker to the outside, and they know where Zonka can work, and that's to the left side of the formation. And it looked to me like then D.D. Lewis almost tackled Zonka as he took the hand off.
Second down and 9. Goldstein, the quarterback. Coder and Zonka, the running backs. Goldstein to throw, and does. Lewis, the interception. To the 30, to the 25, D.D. Lewis. Out of bounds at the 5 for the Cowboys, knocked out by Gordon Gravel.
There he is. And watch him hide in the shadow, or really he's out in the sun, but he has the short zone. Goldstein does not see. Tucker looks open. Look at this. And Tucker goes right onto the bench. He knew he was covered from the underside, but the rookie quarterback didn't. By the way, they regrouped and really put on a run back, didn't they?
Thomas Henderson out in front with a spectacular block. He just leveled one of the Giant players. First, right at the 10-yard line is where they ruled that D.D. Lewis stepped out of bounds. First down and 10 at the 10. To Newhouse. Ducks under one, spins for another. What an effort by Newhouse. He turned nothing into 5 yards.
Brian Kelly has a real good shot at him early, and then Archer had a shot at him late, but again, Newhouse is about as short as you can be and carry 207 or 8 pounds. Look at this. Looked like he was on the gymnastics mat doing some kind of a walkover.
They got the ball in such a place that I'm not sure if it's second and goal at the 6 or if it's second and 6. I don't believe they can make it first down without making a touchdown. Preston Pearson to about the 2.
Wow. Jeter really buried him. Number 70 can move. Now there's McVay. He knows this is a very crucial time for the Giants. After the turnover, they got to be tough on defense. Watch number 70 to the left of your screen. 6'4", 260, a number one draft out of USC.
You know, in recent history, the Giants have had a reputation, although they haven't beaten the Cowboys many times. They beat them 14-6 in 1974, but they have been playing them tough lately.
Boy, they have.
So it's third down and 2 at the 2. Staubach, touchdown.
That is a great call by a great quarterback. And he used a miss. Watch him use the misdirection, Pat, when he moves his head. Watch him act like oop, and then ducks back inside. You can see that Mendenhall had taken that first head movement, which he had to do. He can do so many things as your signal caller.
He really set up the block by his center with that head juke. John Fitzgerald's job was made a lot easier by that maneuver. A friend Herrera with Charlie Waters holding. 7-0 Dallas. 8 minutes, 20 seconds. Here's the touchdown play again. Watch that.
Ground level action. Staubach using just a fraction of a second to juke you out of position.
8 minutes and 20 seconds left to play in the first quarter at Texas Stadium. Cowboys score first. They lead the Giants 7-0.
Europe's most successful new car in history comes to America. Introducing Fiesta. Now imported from Germany by Ford. Fiesta. It gave European drivers the precise control of rack and pinion steering. And road-gripping Michelin radial tires. The power that took it from 0 to 50 in an average of 8.8 seconds. And front disc brakes that brought it from 50 to 0 in an average of 3.3 seconds. Fiesta has the traction and control of front-wheel drive, yet it also has excellent gasoline economy and a modest base sticker price. Fiesta, test drive Europe's most successful new car in history at more than 5,000 authorized Ford dealers across America.
A friend Herrera teeing it up for the Dallas Cowboys after an interception by D.D. Lewis. Took the Cowboys 3 plays to score from the 10. Roger Staubach going in from the 2.
Opportunity, that's what the Dallas team took advantage of, right?
Boy, that's what you got to do. Herrera with Gordon Bell and Bobby Hammond back deep for the Giants. Herrera comes out of the shadows and into the sunshine to kick it. It's going to be Hammond. About a yard deep in the end zone. And Hammond with some room. Hit down by Jay Salvi, I believe. This telecast is presented by authority of the National Football League. It's intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Dallas Cowboys and the National Football League is prohibited. What about the scoreboard, Tom?
Okay, it's a Mosley 26-yard field goal for the Redskins. That's a Bakken field goal. We know how many he missed last week. A 3-0 lead over Chicago.
Get to the rest of the scores in a minute. That's Doug Coder on first down from the 26. Fumble. Dallas has it. The Cowboys recover the fumble at the Dallas 27. Let's see who got it. I think it was Cliff Harris.
All right, Coder used to carry the ball in the left arm and sometimes not protect it. He was protecting it this time early. Too Tall Jones is already gone, and it looks like he tries to keep his balance at the last minute, and Cliff Harris did come up with that fumble recovery, huh?
And there's Doug Coder. Got hit hard and hit the ground hard. Staubach going for the bundle right off. For Drew Pearson, got him. At the 11, stopped by Bill Bryant.
A heck of a tackle by Bryant. What they did was send Golden Richard straight up the field on the far side, and this is an under pattern, and we've said it too many times, but nobody does this better than Drew Pearson. Excellent protection, a very deep drop by Roger, and boy, he could really zero in. Watch the recovery now by Bryant. Heck of an effort in the secondary.
Information is that it was not Cliff Harris, it was Randy White who recovered that fumble. Here's Staubach bringing the ball back to Pearson, who gets inside the 15. That was a first and 10 situation for Dallas. John Mendenhall.
Interesting story on Mendenhall. He arrived a little bit late. He did not make the team playing, and McVay and people were worried about whether, you know, John was in the right mental attitude to play, but he made a great stop there, so it looks like 64's got it together.
Well, there was a little altercation during the week between between Mendenhall and Dan Lloyd.
It's part of the game, isn't it?
Games are on Sunday. Second down situation has Pearson into the secondary to the 4-yard line. Stopped by Brian Kelly. But there, as we told you in our opening comments, is the reason you have not heard too much of Tony Dorsett.
Watch Carson, number 53 now. Scott puts a heck of a block on him, number 68, and just buries him. And Pearson just seems to grease the hole. It doesn't have to be big. Just be there.
He bounced to about the 4. They put the ball back at the 5, where it's first and goal for the Cowboys. They already lead 7-0. We still have 6:19 left in the first period. Dallas is close again. Pearson. Maybe a yard, not much more. Gary Jeter closed it down nicely. There is number 33, a very famous fellow who used to be Tony Dorsett.
And contrary to some of the things you'll be hearing, there's no problem with obviously he or Preston Pearson. And Dorsett to me seems like a great young player that's just waiting for his chance. I see no impatience, at least obvious to us up here.
Certainly not. He's conducted himself very well. Second down. Hand off to Pearson. He lost it.
Carson may have that ball. No, it's Mendenhall that comes out with it, and he's going to turn it.
We'll watch him isolated now.
All right, you're down in there close now. Let's see what happens. Mendenhall, great coming off on that first charge. Runs through Rafferty. Boy, that ball was loose. He and Carson go for it. And Noseman comes out with it. There he goes.
Troy Archer is the one who stripped the ball from Pearson. So the Giants take over, and Dallas comes away with no points. They still lead 7-0.
I mean, it was really a good movie.
It was good,
yeah.
Wasn't it?
Oh, honey, look, some poor guy left his lights on.
Larry.
Is he going to be in trouble?
Larry.
Boy, am I glad it isn't me.
Larry, It is you.
It is me.
Oh. The Die Hard has extra power to start your car when most batteries won't. Starting soon in your neighborhood. Sold only at Sears.
From the people who brought you Die Hard batteries, Road Handler tires, and Steady Rider shock absorbers comes the Sears Muzzler, the aluminized muffler that's only $19.99 installed. It's so tough, Sears promises the muzzler will last as long as you own your American-made car, or return it for refund or replacement free. And if Sears installed it, they'll install the new one free. The muzzler, only $19.99 installed, only at Sears.
Watch the spectacular television premiere of That's Entertainment Part 2 tonight, starting at 8, 7 Central and Mountain Time, right here.
The Giants in the right side of your picture, standing back in their own end zone after Troy Archer knocked the ball loose from Preston Pearson. And John Mendenhall came up with the football. Dallas looked like they might take a 14-0 lead. Instead, it's Giant ball at the 5. First down. Zunka looking for room. Does not get it. Aaron Kyle came up from the outside.
He found it late, though, didn't he? And
yeah.
This, during the 2 or 3 years, 72, 73, 74, nobody made a total offense like number 39. I'll never forget with the Dolphins when he went into the playoffs and against Cincinnati, Oakland, and Minnesota in a row, they took the opening drive and shoved him right down people's throat, and it set up the tone for anything that Bob Greasy at that time wanted to do, and he could still be that kind of a factor, I'll tell you.
Bob Tucker, the tight end to the right side. Zonka got about 3, make it 2nd and 7. That's Willie Spencer, who has replaced Coder at halfback. Spencer, who played for Memphis in the WFL, played for John McVay, and actually played instead of Larry Zonka when Zonka was hurt in those years.
By the way, Patrick, I was up in New York for the luncheon. The Touchdown Club of New York gave you the Golden Mike Award, and I was extremely proud to go up and have a liquid libation or two in your behalf, and it was excellent, and we're really proud of you.
I was extremely proud that you came. 3rd and 7. The Giants' Jerry Goldstein under center. Does not gamble, goes to Zonka. Not enough for the first down, and Dave Jennings will come on.
Boy, the big guy's in good shape, though. He gave it a pretty good shot. The two carries he had total about 8 yards.
Well, he's down in weight. He's down to about 232. And that'll make it easier on that knee.
Yeah, and the knee, by the way, the repair was excellent, and that has given him no problem at all. He's quite an unselfish guy, though. You know that? He's quite a football player.
Dave Jennings back to punt with his back to you there, number 13, standing in his own end zone. Butch Johnson, the Dallas returner. They did not try to block the first punt, but watch him come this time.
Oh, he's kicking good.
A lot of whistles. And I don't know what the problem is. Maybe they took too much time, or Dallas might have jumped off sides. If so, it would be a giant first down, but from the indication so far, let's see.
Doesn't sound like...
Sounds like it's very popular with the Dallas fans. Too much time. It's a violation.
Delay of game, New York, northbound.
Delay of game is the same thing as too much time.
I tell you, Jennings, that's right. Jennings can kick the football, though, and that is so important these days, especially with a young offensive team like that.
And now Jennings about 5 yards deeper in his own end zone. Gets it off and gets it off high and to the right. Johnson fields it at the 40. Inside the 35 down to the 32. He took it in full stride. That punt took off from Jennings' foot like it was going to be better than it turned out to be. Brian Kelly is the guy who made the tackle, so with 3 minutes and 18 seconds left in the first period, it is still Dallas 7, the New York Giants nothing.
Sir, we all know Mobil 1 is the oil that saves you gas. Give me another good reason to buy it.
Well, it lasts. And lasts.
How long will Mobil 1 last? We drove it 15,000 miles without an oil change, and after all that, found Mobil 1 still protects as well as new ordinary oil.
And lasts. Lasts.
Mobil 1, the oil that saves you gas, saves you oil changes.
Stuntman. You get the bruises instead of the glory. You hit the deck and bite the dust till your bones ache. But now comes Miller time. Time to reach for the best tasting beer you can find. Miller High Life, America's quality beer.
If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
Miller beer.
At Texas Stadium in Dallas.
Oh, yes.
No place quite like it.
I'll tell you one thing, though. I ate some Mexican food last night, and I was under siege the entire evening. The team eats that. They're pretty tough the next day, I'll tell you.
That's their pregame meal. First and 10, Cowboys. Staubach fakes to Pearson. Ball is deflected. Troy Archer, I believe, got a big paw up and knocked it down.
Boy, he and Jeter both had their arms up. Again, that is a young defensive line, other than, of course, Mendenhall and Gregory. But those other two people, Jeter and Archer, you're going to be reading a lot about them and hearing about them a long time. They're young and they're healthy. Chicago and St. Louis are now tied 3-3. That's in the first quarter still. Washington over Atlanta 3-0 still in the first. Baltimore 14, the Jets nothing, and that's in the first.
Second and 10, Pearson gets the call, and look at him pop it. Through the left side, Harry Carson, the middle linebacker, I believe made the first contact, and so did Jim Steinke help out. Watch it from the end zone. Watch the hole open.
All right, let's see it to the right of your screen. The stunt was on by the Giant defense. Archer took himself out, and Newhouse took care of Mendenhall, and it did leave a hole. If you stunt on defense, you got to make sure everybody makes it to the designated area, or you're really in trouble.
Third down coming up now. Ball at the Giant 25, at the... Yes, the Giant 25, third and two, the situation. Outside Pearson. Got the first down. Bobby Bryant.
We watched Roger Staubach last week against Minnesota, and even though he was 60%, until the last driver, so it didn't look like he threw it well. This pass was thrown well. Of course, third and two, it's a good call. And I'll tell you, Bryant kept slippery there from going right down the sidelines. Pearson made it look like he was going to step out and then tried to duck it.
I said Bobby Bryant. It's Billy Bryant. Pearson shifts deep. It's first down at the 16. The man is back to Newhouse. They shut that one off pretty well. Jeter and Troy Archer.
You realize that the big change in the Giants since McVay took over last year has been the defense. They're allowing people about an average over the last eight games, seven last year and one this year, of about 12 points a game allowed. And they're not making at least the crucial mistake on defense, and they really tightened that part of their game up.
Jeter just beat that block by Donovan. Second and eight. Pearson goes to the left. Newhouse gets the call, and a rather strange one. He rolls the inside to 10. Brad Van Pelt and Clyde Powers.
Boy, Neely and Van Pelt really had a great Mexican standoff, the offensive tackle against the big linebacker.
Tom Landry. Those notes that he carries in his hand throughout every contest are just reminders as he shuttles his wide receivers and calls the plays.
Wouldn't you think he'd take his coat off today? It must be 200 down there.
Gotta be. Well, his shade is on that side, though. Maybe it's only 115. Roger Staubach fires wide open with Preston Pearson. Nobody near.
There's the experience of Preston Pearson. You can't do what he's done for 11 years and not know where people are. I think Stanky, the safety man, had the first man out. Watch to the right of your screen now, and you'll see 20 being taken out, and Pearson will come back across the middle. We're sorry about this picture, but that's because of the sunlight coming through this roof down here. I'm not going to try to say Stanky had the coverage, but it looked to me like he just thought Pearson was going to duck outside, and instead he went inside.
He delayed just a little bit, just long enough. Waters holding Herrera, making it 14-0 Dallas. 1 minute and 11 seconds left to play in the first period. Let's watch Jeter on that last play.
Jeter working on Donovan, two big young professionals. Jeter takes the inside and gets away with it. Donovan tries to clip him and doesn't do it. Hey, that Jeter looks like he has the right idea. That's the one he was after.
14-0. The Dallas Cowboys lead the Giants with 1 minute and 11 seconds left to play in the first period. That touchdown set up by a fine punt return by Butch Johnson. Let's see what's happening as far as the scoreboard around the league is concerned.
21 Cincinnati Bengals, 21 Seattle, nothing in the first period. Looks like the Bengals found their offense finally. Chicago 3, St. Louis 3. We're keeping you obviously aware of that score. And I'll tell you the truth, I'm having trouble going through all these notes to give you all those scores. I'm going to have to look over my bookkeeping here.
Fran Herrera, who is not, by the way, a United States citizen. He still has to go back to Mexico. And
how often?
I think once every 6 weeks.
Not too bad.
Picked up another work permit. He works well, too. Line drive. This will be Gordon Bell from the two. Bell. I saw a shoe come flying out of the end of that pile.
The Giants really went after Efren Herrera, the man we were just talking about, the kicker, just to perhaps intimidate him should a field goal be a deciding factor. Boy, right now, the Giant offense has got to get the load off that defense and move the football if they can.
They surely do. The defense has spent an awful lot of time on the field in that first quarter. First down, Giants at their own 31. They trail 14-0. Goldstein. Outside Robinson. Benny Barnes right there. Looked like he could have been Walt Harrison.
Jimmy Robinson is only 5'9", 170 pounds, and now I think they're calling something. Here's the out. Now we've got sort of pumping iron, and Harris came over and took a shot. I don't even believe Cliff Harris made contact, but it looked like he did.
Bill Gregory is pushing Cliff Harris back. Charlie Waters is over still arguing. I don't know if the violation was against Barnes or Harris, but we'll find out from referee Gordon McCarter as soon as they step it off.
It's going to be unsportsmanlike, I think, but actually Robinson wasn't on the ground yet. I thought he was still three. Maybe he was King's X.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. 43 defense.
Was against Cliff Harris.
All I know, if you know any safeties, though, tell them to go ahead and take that shot and worry about the flag later.
Tell them to play like Cliff Harris. First down, Giants, right at midfield. Goldstein pitches back to Bobby Hammond. Great Dallas pursuit. Too tall, Jones, Cliff Harris.
Patrick, that's the scary thing about the Cowboys, is that they have great speed and size. Too tall, 6'9", and he gets back to the outside and helps your linebacker on a play like that. And I'll tell you, the little man can run that just ran that play. They are not only large, but they are mobile as all get out.
Staggering and frightening to think that they've got 9 rookies on the team this year. 2 years ago, they had 12. So just in those 2 years, there are 21 men. They have rebuilt and stayed close to the top at the same time. Hammond. The big hand of Larry Cole came out to stop him.
Hammond's a little slow getting up. He's also a smaller back.
He looked over to the side and said, I need some help. Bobby Hammond strolls over. That's the end of the first quarter with Dallas leading on a hot afternoon in Dallas, 14-0 over New York.
When it's so cold, a radiator can freeze solid, and you're still rolling. That's the mark of Xerex. When it's so hot, a radiator can blow its top, and you're still driving cool. That's the mark of Xerex. When corrosion is eating holes in radiators, and you're still going strong. That's the mark of Xerex. Start fresh now with year-round protection. That's the mark of Xerex. Are you still chained to? Gotcha. The rechargeable Norelco Rotary Razor lets you walk away, free from nicks and cuts. Its 36 surgical steel rotary razor blades are safely protected inside 3 floating heads to give you a comfortable shave that's razor close, razor smooth, for up to 3 weeks on a single charge. The rechargeable Norelco Rotary Razor. It lets you walk away from. Gotcha.
The Ford in your future is coming. The new Ford Fairmont. A new car designed for today and the years ahead. Fairmont's mileage ratings are the same as a little VW Rabbit when both are equipped with automatic transmission. Yet Fairmont has 90% of the head, leg, and shoulder room of most large cars and fine all-around visibility. This kind of room is combined with the highest mileage rating in its class. Test drive Fairmont October 7th. Fairmont, the newest better idea from Ford.
Dallas 14-0, a touchdown by Roger Staubach on a 2-yard run and a touchdown on a pass from Staubach to Preston Pearson.
Got one interesting score here I found. Detroit 7, New Orleans 14. The Saints 14-7 over Detroit in the second period. Looks like Stram's got the Saints back into football gear, huh?
It'll be third down for Dallas. The ball just in Dallas for New York, I beg your pardon. Just in Dallas territory. The blitz was on. Goldstein dropped it, and now he goes down. Randy Hughes just barely got a hand on him as he went by on a blitz.
And perhaps a veteran quarterback would have stepped up anyway when he saw the blitz. Now watch Goldstein go back. He is 6'4", agile at 210. He doesn't think there's going to be any rush, but it's just the shoulder pad, and then he didn't have the ball firmly grasped, and it's worse than an INC. It's almost a sack.
So we'll see Dave Jennings back to punt for the Giants. It puts Johnson back at his own 15 for Dallas. Good kick. At the 14. Johnson gets outside the 20. The fans think the flag should be thrown, but none is.
super coverage, I'll tell you that. Al Dixon was down there for the Giants like a shot, number 88. Think the crowd wanted some kind of a flag to fall, do you?
I think so. That was my reaction, or what I got from them. Dallas will take it over. CBS Sports Spectacular presents the World's Strongest Men competition. Also the Cup and the Super Bowl of Motocross next Saturday at 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time. And that's quite a collection of strong men that we'll tell you about later in the afternoon. First and 10, Dallas. Ball at their own 22-yard line. They lead 14-0 over New York. This is Scott Laidlaw, I believe.
We've seen a lot of man-to-man coverage by the Giants, which I understand, but as John Simak has said, he's rebuilding in the secondary now for New York. And man-to-man coverage looks great as long as it's really operating. But boy, when you break it, you break the defense for 6 points, which we've already seen. That is a good, aggressive defense, but they are young and they're just getting it together.
Laidlaw got three on his first carry, so it's second and 7 for Dallas, the ball at their own 25. Opening minutes of period number 2 at Texas Stadium. Pearson shifts back deep. Laidlaw again. Stopped right at the line of the scrimmage by Troy Archer.
That's incredible. Watch number 77 now. They're running straight at the young tackle, who is playing, by the way, with a strained knee. And he said he was going to try to give it a shot anyway, and he is active.
He has given it a good shot. There's Troy Archer.
He's a chess and ski bum and a horticulturist, too. You know what that is.
What a combination. Shotgun combination right here. A lot of jumping around by Dallas. Protection is forever. Caught. Colin Richard. Jim Steinke on the coverage. Out to the 42, where it'll be a Dallas first down. Joe Pisarcik, the Giants' backup quarterback, warming up.
Also in his first year in the NFL. Here's the play from the shotgun. The blind snap by Fitzgerald right on. Roger goes back into that shadow and throws. Now, Rhodes had the short zone. And you can see that Golan just pulled it up inside. Pretty clever player, number 83.
And the Dallas setbacks are now Scott Laidlaw and Tony Dorsett. And this is Dorsett. Broke one. Got away from Brian Kelly, but Ray Rhodes.
Rhodes is an interesting story. One of
he
the
is.
Very fine receivers for a couple of years, but had played defensive cornerback at Tulsa. So they said, you want to play corner? And he said, I love it. And it looks to me like Rhodes' career is going to be a long one and a very good one at cornerback. That's a crazy switch. I never heard of anybody going from the good guys to the bad guys like Rhodes did.
Heard him going the other way. No gain for Dorsett. Dorsett breaks one. Close to a first down. In fact, he got the first down before he was stopped by Brad Van Pelt.
Whatever you do, if you're playing defense against 33, don't let him get the second or third foot on the ground free. As soon as you get near him, grab it. That's what the Giants are trying to do. Watch this acceleration. That's what you got to worry about. Van Pelt hadn't have been there then. They might have been heading him off at the pass.
Van Pelt hurt himself when he fell on that artificial turf, and he had to be taken out.
Dorsett. Boy, he is instantaneous action off the snap, isn't he?
He really is. First down, Dallas, and Dorsett gets another crack. Tries to get to the outside and does. Breaks another couple. He is exciting. Troy Archer again on the tackle. There's Brad Van Pelt. Looks like he fell right on his shoulder.
Yeah. Boy, there's one of the guys that has come along to be a solid linebacker. Now watch Dorsett. He almost turns this play back against the grain, and if he does, he's gone. And I think that about every other play you're going to see 33 make is going to be a great defensive effort, or he's going to be going someplace.
Frank Marion took Van Pelt's place, by the way. Staubach deep, gives to Dorsett. Number 25. Harry Carson and Brian Kelly converge. It looks like both of them might be shaken.
All right, this is something we haven't thought about. Obviously, at Pittsburgh, he didn't get a chance to do this. He just dies and waits for it. The Giants had long gone in pursuit of Staubach, and I'll tell you now, you've got a problem. He puts two Giants out. They knock each other down. Brian Kelly, and I don't know who the other player is down there.
The other one is Carson. So that's all three of the linebackers who've been hurt in the last three plays. 14-0 Dallas with just over 10 minutes left to play before halftime.
Okay, Linda here's got to protect her family.
A woman?
Sure, a woman needs life insurance just as much as a man does. And this New York Life Defense has just the insurance plan to do it. Put the blitz on Linda's money problems. Block out her retirement worries. Come on, Linda, it's all yours now. And a girl!
I've got it. Financial security.
Where the name of the game is life, there's New York Life.
Announcing a unique new motor oil from Exxon Research that can actually save money. New Golden Natural Uniflow. Uniflow was tested in cars like yours. After break-in, it delivered an overall average of 16 extra miles per tank full. Savings like that could cut your gasoline bill the equivalent of about 3 cents a gallon. New Uniflow motor oil is Exxon's best engine protection ever. It conserves gasoline, saves money.
That's Harry Carson, who's still down, and let's look at what caused it.
All right, as we said, Tony Dorsett in two plays has wiped out the linebacking core of the New York Giants. That's Kelly and Carson there. Van Pelt left the play earlier, and I noticed the Giants have gone into the shade on the far side of the field, just trying to get a little bit of a respite while a middle linebacker is being administered to.
That linebacker problem has been solved somewhat by the fact that Brian Kelly seems to be all right. And Brad Van Pelt is back over one of those in the shade over there with his back to you.
Comes Archer over to check on the big middle linebacker. I think the thing is that Dorsett may be so darn quick that you don't get the body you shoot at, and you end up hitting somebody else that's trying to do the same thing.
So with Carson coming out and Brian Kelly recovering and Brad Van Pelt being back in the game, it is now Dan Lloyd, number 54, the third Giant linebacker. The rest of the defense remains just as it was.
A San Diego 13, Kansas City 7 in the second period. Green Bay has Houston down. It's the Packers 7-0 over the Oilers. That's in the first period. That was a 40-yard pass from Lynn Dickey to somebody else.
Right here, there are 9 minutes and 50 seconds left before the half. Dallas leads 14-0. They have the ball at the Giant 25-yard line, first and 10. Dorsett and Laidlaw, the running backs behind Staubach. Scott Laidlaw with the forward handoff, scoops to the 20. To about the 17-yard line before he's stopped by Jim Stanky. But good yardage for Scott Laidlaw.
Oh, boy, and Scott, number 68, the offensive guard, got outside, and the Giants had collapsed it down so far that the hole that Laidlaw ran through was 7 or 8 yards wide.
It was an 8-yard pickup. So make it second and 2, Dallas. The ball at the 17. Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire at Texas Stadium, watching the Cowboys and the Giants. Back to Dorsett. Flag goes down. Dorsett out of bounds at about the 10. By Van Pelt.
They threw it almost on Ralph Neely's back, so it may be a holding call against the Cowboys. The Giants didn't get Dorsett down again, you know. He walked out of bounds standing still.
What acceleration he's got. Joe Pisarcik.
What's his nickname, you and I were told?
Patterson Plank Joe.
That was Broadway. Broadway Joe, now there's Patterson Plank Joe.
That's the road that goes by the stadium in the Meadowlands. Here's Gordon McCarter.
Holding, 89 offense, second down.
Holding is called against number 89, Billy Joe Dupree.
Looks like Carson is still not feeling good, and it's very hot in which to recover, I'll tell you that, though.
Second and 12 for Dallas. Draw play, Laidlaw, nothing doing. Troy Archer again.
Notice J.T. Turner is in there now, and Mendenhall is out. J.T. Turner is the backup defensive lineman there for a couple of them. Mendenhall is not in the game right now, and we'll try to see if he has been hurt or not.
Harry Carson still down by the Giant bench. Looks like they might be getting ready for a trip to the locker room for him. Third down, Cowboys. The protection is excellent. Bill Bryant, but Drew Pearson.
I think you tipped it off, Pat, when you said the protection was excellent. They're trying to stunt on the defensive line. The Cowboys pick it up, and Roger can see straight down the middle. By the way, that's the shortest distance you can throw the pass, you know, is down the middle, and of course, Pearson can catch it if he slides into second base.
He slid it about the 1 foot line. Where it is now, first and goal for Dallas. They already lead 14-0. 7.5 minutes left in the second period. Scott Laidlaw and Doug Dennison, now one of the setbacks, the deep one. It is Dennison. Dallas now has 20.
Looks like Jack Gregory is down now, and he's on the 3-yard line rolling over. No, I'm sorry, that's Van Pelt again. He's holding his arm this time, and he's in pain.
Here's the touchdown again.
Nobody can score from the two any better than Dennison, I'll tell you that. He's a short yardage master.
He was also the Cowboys' leading rusher last year. Van Pelt has problems with his right forearm, as you can obviously see.
Pat, I saw Mendenhall down on the bench, and he's got a towel over his head. Like he has sort of been run too, so the Giants are not only thin, but now they're hurting.
Maybe Mendenhall's problem might be just the heat. Herrera makes it Dallas 21. The New York Giants, nothing. There's John Mendenhall trying to get cooled off. It is extremely hot on that playing field.
Sit tight, Pop. I'll pump myself. Let me tell you something, gang. Any gas will get you where you want to go. But it ought to be in there cleaning your carburetor, too. Now, you want to make sure you're getting the job done, use new STP gas treatment. You just pump in a can with every tank load of gas, and it goes to work cleaning like a bandit. Clean that carburetor. Get a hold of this, and do it yourself. Keep the change, partner.
Leslie Caron for Color Track by RCA.
In Gigi, my brooch was blue, the leaves were green, and my gown was lavender lace. If these colors don't look right to you, you should know about Color Track from RCA. Getting the color right is what Color Track is all about. It actually adjusts the colors and locks them on track.
Before you see the color, the Color Track system grabs it, aligns it, defines it, sharpens it, tones it, and locks the color on track.
RCA is making television better and better.
60 Minutes takes you on a stakeout as government agents move in on the mob. Tonight at 7, 6 Central and Mountain Time.
Number 53 is Giant middle linebacker Harry Carson, who's just left the field. We don't know the nature of his injuries yet. As soon as we find it out, we'll let you know. Our friend Herrera to kick it off now. Bobby Hammond and Gordon Bell deep for New York. 21-0 Dallas. Herrera off the inside of the foot. It'll be Bobby Hammond. Hammond about the 31. Scott Laidlaw and Mike Hegman made the tackle.
And that's Hammond's third good run back. They've had good position after the kickoff. He's got it out to the 30 all three times. Uh-oh, here's a score. Baltimore 20, the Jets 3. McCauley scored from the 1 for Baltimore. That's a third quarter score, and Looks like Walt Michaels' team has run into a buzzsaw. Baltimore's coming on again.
Larry Zonka's come out of the game. The running backs, I believe, are going to be Spencer and Bobby Hammond. Willie Spencer's as big as Zonka. New quarterback is the sergeant. He forgot the ball. Harvey Martin got it. Exchange from center between Vasarchik, number nine, and Hill didn't come off. It'll be a Dallas first down at the Giant 30.
I wonder if Vasarchik even got a snap on the sidelines from Hill warming up. The snap is a very firm thing by those centers, and it looks like the young quarterback never even realized he had the football.
Ralph Hill, the offensive center, and Vasarchik, who had just come in. So it'll be first and 10, Dallas. Roger Staubach still the quarterback. Newhouse now, and Dorsett the running backs, and it'll be Newhouse. Trying to get outside, could not. Frank Marion, number 51, the linebacker, the substitute linebacker. There's Tom Landry. Sending in plays. Right now he's talking to Butch Johnson.
All right, Harry Carson is being taken to the hospital for examination of his lower back. We're not saying that's an injury or anything else, but it's examination, and of course the doctors were there, and that's one thing about the new modern stadium. They have x-ray facilities and all right here at this ballpark.
Scott Laidlaw has replaced Newhouse now. Fake draw to Laidlaw. Pearson again. Bill Bryant on the coverage, but a perfect strike from Staubach. What can you do?
And again, it's right down the middle. You've got the linebackers are hurt now. Carson's not in there anymore. The draw will keep the linebackers as close as possible. Good blocking. And this is a short throw. It's a lot shorter than going deep corner when you can look right down the rifle barrel and fire to number 88, I'll tell you.
Staubach has hit 8 out of 10 so far. It's a first down, Dallas. Ball at the Giant 11. First and 10. Dorsett.
There's number one. Looked like they trapped Turner. It's a false trap. They ran everybody away and peeled back with the other back to block. Now he would have scored in a touch game out in Central Park.
Tony Dorsett's first NFL touchdown. And as Tom Brookshire said,
registered over the last 12 years, 93 out of 100 are still on the job.
One step closer. One step closer. One step closer. That's what Exxon people say. One step closer. At the end of every day, Exxon's dedicated to finding energy for you. Energy for a strong America.
Our friend Herrera teeing it up for Dallas. Tony Dorsett just scored on an 11-yard run to make it Dallas 28. The Giants nothing. 6 minutes, 16 seconds left in the second period.
Remember, Dallas opened against Minnesota. Some people thought that would hurt them, but it has to have gotten them pretty tuned in for things.
They look pretty well tuned right now. Herrera in the direction of Emory Moorhead, but Gordon Bell takes it 5 yards deep in the end zone and kneels. There's our friend.
There's my man, Whistling Ray. In between those Texas Rangers stars and having a ball. Chaps and all.
I wouldn't say he's the number one Cowboy fan, but he's got to be pretty close to number one.
He doesn't have a care in the world today, I'll tell you.
Don't forget the CBS Sports Spectacular next Saturday at 4:30 p.m. Eastern Time. The world's strongest men competition. They'll lift a barrel full of weights next week. Liquid shot in the barrel. I don't know how heavy it's going to be, but you got to be pretty strong to get it up off the ground. It's 150 pounds, I'm told. Fumble by Robinson, but I believe he might have been down. Tesarchuk got the ball to him.
Tesarchuk threw a pretty good pass, too. It was a little low, but Robinson is short to start with. A little inside, quick move. He was down.
Cliff Harris and Bob Brunig on the tackle. Also on the Sports Spectacular next week. The fifth running of the Cup. $250,000 purse. Second of the Fall Triple Crown Handicap for three-year-olds and up. And the Super Bowl of motocross. That's all on the CBS Sports Spectacular next week. First down, New York. Bobby Hammond swings wide to the right and cuts back inside. Bill Gregory, who was hurt and didn't dress out against Minnesota last week.
I tell you, that time Hicks and Van Horn both got out in good shape in front of the play. They took the deep belly and made a pretty good offensive play out of it. They picked up half of that first down. And it's going to be interesting to see how the Giants, as a young team, react to this onslaught. They can either roll it over or they can come back now and play good football.
Second and five will make it. Ball at the Giant 39 in their possession. Joe Tesarchuk, the quarterback. He gives to Hammond. Ed Jones, number 72, Randy White. Bob Brunig, number 53, is the middle linebacker for the Cowboys. Leroy Jordan was there for oh so many years. It's a first down for Hammond on that last run. John McVay, by the way, is calling plays by shuttling wide receivers. Jerry Goldstein, who started at quarterback for the Giants, has a slight concussion. It was a tough day for him.
Again, the Giants are sitting in that sun, and the visiting team always gets the bad shower head and the bad sun field, right?
The small lockers. Tesarchuk, the fake draw. Firing deep. Caught. Johnny Perkins, the Giants' number two draft choice, took that pass. Look at Tesarchuk.
Tesarchuk is the one that we talked about that is still a rookie, but he's played some Canadian ball, but this is his first really league game. All three Giant quarterbacks are rookies, and Perkins from Abilene Christian can motor. And I'm telling you, Big Joe put a heave on this one. It's hard to beat the Dallas secondary over the top, and Perkins makes a super incredible grab down there.
Now is Aaron Kyle, number 25, the Dallas defender. But the Giants have it first and goal at the Cowboy one-yard line. 28-0, Dallas leads. 3 minutes, 35 seconds about will be left before the half by the time they get this playoff. The Giants now dealing in the shadows at Texas Stadium. Zonka is one of the running backs. Spencer is the other. And Spencer does not get in.
Boy, Zonka and Spencer should be a load back there in close. There's the signal on how close it is.
From ground level.
All right, let's take a look at it. Again, that's the first unit for Dallas in there. Make no mistake. Van Horn's working on the... Zonka gets clubbed, and he didn't even have the ball.
Looks like about a foot. A second down situation now. The running backs are the same. Spencer is deep. Zonka is close to Tesarchuk. Spencer, touchdown. The Giants get on the board.
And Tesarchuk has quite a drive. The big deep bomb, pass before that, and a first down on two running plays. And this Joe's doing a pretty good job.
Here's the touchdown again.
As we said, the team could have gone either way with a 28-0 lead in the first half. Looks like they've decided to make a fight of it in the second half. that is something else. Henderson went over the top.
Joe Dinello with Larry Mallory holding. Down the pipe. Dallas 28, the Giants 7. 2:56 left, second period. You know, you're so right. In a situation like this, when you get down so quickly, sometimes you find out who really wants to play then.
the three rookie quarterbacks means that your leadership has to come from the Bob Tuckers and the Hicks and people like that. It's not impossible, and I'll tell you, McVay's done a heck of a job. But it is more difficult. I'll tell you one thing. This young man that went to school in Las Cruces, New Mexico, at New Mexico State's pretty loose. He fumbled that first snap, and looks like he might have been a little bit mad at himself.
He was up at one point for Sarchik about 260 pounds. Now he's about 218.
260?
Yeah. They had an off-season training camp, and he came in and weighed 260. All during training camp this year, he kept doing good things. They kept saying, we've got to cut this guy. And he kept saying, you can't do it. I've done too well. Don't forget to stick around at halftime. Join Brent, Phyllis, and Irv. They'll bring you up to date on all the scores. That is Larry Brimson, rookie from Florida. Swinging out to the outside to the 31. Cowboys, by the way, are very high on that young man. He was a free agent.
Made Jensen and a few other people that have been around for a couple of years extremely available.
He goes about 220.
And he's got those bow legs with the pigeon toes, the kind of Jimmy Brown footwork that can run right over the top of you at great speed.
And make you very difficult to knock down, too. Cowboy first down at their own 31. Roger Staubach still the quarterback. Tony Dorsett and Scott Laidlaw, the deep backs.
Dallas has got big splits on that line of scrimmage.
Laidlaw looking for someplace and not finding it. John Mendenhall back in the game. Brad Van Pelt has got an ice pack strapped to his right arm. Being administered to on the sideline.
I tell you, that Jeter, number 70 you're looking at right there for the Giants, is going to be some football player. Number one draft choice. That's a young man out there playing against one of the best teams in football and doing a heck of a job. He's going to be something.
Second and nine, and we're going to watch Mr. Jeter on his next play. Dallas 28, Giants 7, Dorsett in motion. Staubach, Pearson outside, did not quite get a first down. But Drew Pearson continues to prove that he is one of the truly outstanding pass receivers in all of football.
Catch three or four crossing patterns. I can't blame Bryant for letting him have a deep sideline.
The communications with the press box by the guy who's running the Giant offense right now. That is Joe Fisarchik.
Here's a few tips on how to get out of an airport fast. One, join the number one club and reserve a car with Hertz. Two, have your license and credit card ready, because Hertz will be ready for you. Just sign and go. Three, need directions? Ask Hertz. They know the shortest routes. Nobody can get you out of an airport faster. Nobody can get you out of an airport faster.
Go, Juice! Go!
Rent a Ford from Hertz.
A superstar in Rent-A-Car.
Ride.
Who is the number one investment firm in the East? Who is the number one investment firm in the Midwest? Who is the number one investment firm in the South? Who is the number one investment firm in the West? You know who. Merrill Lynch. All around America, more investors turn to Merrill Lynch than any other investment firm. Sure, there are lots of investment firms, but there's only one Merrill Lynch.
We mentioned earlier that the Giants' starting quarterback, Jerry Goldstein, had a slight concussion. And there he is right now heading for the locker room. We have 2 minutes to play in the first half. The score is Dallas 28, the Giants 7.
Mendenhall is back in the lineup now, playing the left tackle or the nose, whatever the defense that is called. So they lost George Martin, the big touchdown scorer, last week, and the Giants are having some troubles today.
Third and one.
Great play, John.
Going for the bunch. Billy Joe Dupree has enough to get the first down. Stopped out, knocked out of bounds by number 51, Frank Marion. But Staubach got it out to him and stopped the clock. They used 6 seconds on that play.
Giant defense that time lined up in the Dallas flex with Jeter off the line of scrimmage. And what it turned out to be was that Jeter never got into the pass rush at all. Again, he's a rookie. And it's very hard for rookies to get into sophisticated defenses and pull them off. I saw Big Martin down on the field. George had his 30-yard touchdown pass last week and got his knee hurt in the second quarter for the Giants.
Staubach on first down. A little high for Pearson. Clyde Powers cut in front of Drew. Staubach had to throw a little high.
Well, he's been fooling around with the outside. Three straight passes have been to the outside. I trust number 12 not a little bit. He'll come right back the middle with something deep and an under pattern, and obviously the Giants will be looking for the same thing.
Minute 50 left on the clock before halftime. Ball's at the Dallas 46, second and 10 for them. They lead 28-7 on a hot day in Texas. Ray got a drop back. He's trying to set up a screen. Laidlaw into Giant territory and out of bounds at the 49. Beasley Reese, who used to be a Cowboy, is the guy who shoved him out.
Roger, the devil in this case, because he's the quarterback if you're playing defense, decided to call the screen. Good call, but good recovery by the Giants. Again, you're watching guys that are down 28-7 and trying to get back in the game and doing a pretty good job of it.
Just a 4-yard pickup on that screen. So it'll be 3rd and 5 for the Cowboys. Danny White, the Dallas punter, has had to kick it only once in this entire first half. Staubach. Beasley Reese on the coverage. And they are saying that he perhaps interfered with Tony Dorsett.
I can't believe the flag. Just can't believe the flag. I'm just talking football. That ball is whistling in there now. Big rush by Roger, and he stayed in there. Boy, if you're not allowed to touch that receiver, this game's over.
Pass interference, number 28, defense, automatic first down.
Let's watch Mendenhall on that last play.
Okay, there was some pressure on Roger as a stunt up front. Inside comes the defensive end, and Mendenhall just throws Donovan out of the way and does put some heat on Roger. Also puts the shoulder on Roger.
That's some pretty strong heat. Nevertheless, it's first down for the Dallas Cowboys. A minute 36 left before halftime. Dallas leads 28-7. Shotgun this time. Fluttered outside. Tony Hill, the rookie from Stanford. Covered by Clyde Powers, but the Cowboys are also very high on number 80.
Yeah, and he's big. He's about 6'3", 210 pounds or so. Runs a 4.5 40. And the Dallas Cowboys have that great luxury of great draft choices that have to sit around and study the veterans.
They're stocking up on draft choices again this year.
Yeah, when they get a free agent, though, he's a pretty fair hand. Drew Pearson walked on and said, "Can I play?"
Larry Brinson said the same thing, and they like him a lot. Laidlaw comes back in motion, and then he comes back outside again. And Laidlaw's got it. At the 17-yard line, Scott Laidlaw comes out of bounds, pushed out by Beasley Reese.
The thing that made the play, Pat, was when the man in motion starts back to the right of your screen. Now he goes back out to the left, and suddenly the linebacker that was supposed to follow him across and make the adjustment has to trail him. That's Lloyd making the initial contact there with Laidlaw. They got a lot to the offense, don't they?
Boy, they do. That, again, is one of the reasons that Dorsett did not break in sooner. That and Preston Pearson. But it is so complicated that it just takes a while to learn it. Staubach wants a timeout. Roger walking over to talk to Tom Landry. A minute 24 left before the half. Dallas leads 28-7.
St. Louis 13, the Chicago Bears 3 now. That's a J.V. Kane pass from Jimmy Hart, a 17-yarder at halftime. It's the Cardinals 13, the Chicago Bears 3. That has got to be a shocking score for everybody, including Pardee. Cincinnati 28, Seattle 20. This is in the third period now, as Leipold had a 42-yard field goal, and I'll tell you, Patera has Seattle playing tough football.
He surely does.
Washington 10, Atlanta 3. A 2-yard pass, Kilmer to Mike Thomas. 1:36 left in the fourth period now. They're in the fourth period now. Washington 10, Atlanta 3. The Redskins are going to get even, it looks like.
Of course, at the half, I remind you again that we'll be switching back to New York for highlights and scores at the half. Some highlights here, too.
Well, they even draft well for the girls that ring the stadium. They just seem to find people that can do the job.
How many can they have? 32 of these cheerleaders. How many candidates do they have? Something over 400 or 500, I think.
Texas has about 500,000. They cut it down to this number. They do add something to it.
Yes, they do. Be a very difficult job to be a judge in that contest. Although I wouldn't turn it down.
How about just giving them calisthenics?
Yeah. Oh, well. A minute 24 left before the half. 28-7. Dallas over the Giants. Brinson and Dorsett are now the running backs for the Cowboys. Staubach. Tony Dorsett had it and dropped it, but it would not have mattered because there's a holding penalty about to be called, I'm sure.
Offensive holding on the line of scrimmage. Number 68 was trying to make a move, Turner, and I believe they just tackled him.
68 is Herbert Scott.
One thing of caution to say about the Cowboys, though, and Landry and his staff know this a heck of a lot better than we do, you don't want to get careless because you've run up a lead and begin to make silly mistakes. The holding, the bad execution, not catching the football like Dorsett just did. You don't want to carry that habit over into the rest of the season. You want to finish and cleanly.
Illegal use of hands. Number 67, offense. First down.
67 on offense is Pat Donovan, who has replaced Rayfield Wright at offensive tackle. Rayfield's knee just did not quite heal sufficiently. Pat
Turner.
Donovan.
Turner is now at the left defensive end, and Jeter is finally getting the break on that on the Giants side there. He played very well.
Blessedly, the sun went behind a cloud. The shadows are gone momentarily, and so is a lot of that heat. Blitz is on. Brinson picks it up. Dorsett catches it. Shoved out of bounds on the far side of the field by Larry Mallory. Again.
Out of the double wing setup now, they keep the Brinson back in the block and pick up the blitz. I'll tell you, I don't know when he learns how to run all the pass routes if you're going to be able to cover him at all.
Unofficially now, Staubach is 14 out of 18. He's had a hot hand the first half, obviously.
And when the blitz doesn't get there, your defense goes back and said, hey, what happened to the blitzer? Did he make it or not? And they say, no.
And then they say, well, why did we go? Because that makes it a lot tougher on the coverage. Here is Staubach. The blitz is on again. He did not get away from this one. The ball is loose. And the official has indicated that Staubach's arm had started forward, so the ball will go back to the original line of scrimmage. And this last 2 minutes of this half has been an eternity. Excuse me, Tom.
Here comes Lloyd up the middle. And I tell you, he had a late rush at it, but you could see him making the charge. Roger gets stripped of it. The arm was coming forward. It's funny how when you got it going, the offensive tackle even makes a super recovery.
A minute 10 left in this first half. Cowboys have two timeouts left. The Giants have all three of theirs. Jerry Goldstein has left the scene with a slight concussion. Brad Van Pelt has had to sit down with an injured arm, and Harry Carson has gone to the hospital for an examination. Roger Staubach deals from the shotgun for Drew Pearson. Come up with it. Larry Mallory was one of the defenders. The other was Beasley Reese.
I tell you, Mallory makes a great play from the backside, or Pearson comes up with this.
There's another flag down. Back at about the 25 with 1:05 left on the clock, and it stopped again. Let's see what happened.
That's it.
Holding, number 68. Offense, decline, northbound.
Herbert Scott this time. Jack Gregory, number 81, is still in there. One of the good pass rushers in all of football. Big Jack that time came up the middle, and they tackled him, and here comes Herrera.
Efren Herrera. His first name is spelled E-F-R-E-N.
He has a radio show here in town, doesn't he, on a Spanish-speaking station?
I think he does, yeah.
Reads the funnies and talks about world problems and things.
And on off days, he kicks field goals. About as well as anybody. 31-7. Herrera is good. Charlie Waters was the holder. And the Dallas Cowboys now lead the Giants 31-7 with 1 minute and 2 seconds left before the half. Herrera, of course, will now kick off as a very, very fatigued-looking Giant defensive unit comes off. Here's a guy who never gets tired.
I've seen him when it was a tight score. He's a little bit worried, but today he looks like he's frolicking, doesn't he?
Landry and Starbucks.
Composure personified, and Tom still has the coat on and looks like he's in an air-conditioned room, and I'm telling you, it's 100 degrees where he's standing.
Tell you what, I played against him, with him, and for him. And he was a heck of a good football player.
I'll tell you what's amazing to me is, when, at least when we run into him, he has a big grin on his face all the time. And most people don't see that because he concentrates so much. But, you know, he's sort of a fun guy to at least play for. Or
delightful guy. He was the same kind of player as Cliff Harris.
Is that right? A little bit rough, too, huh?
Tough. He was a halfback on a team that went to the Orange Bowl that had Bobby Lane as the quarterback.
Had to be tough.
And they just killed George. Yeah, you did, didn't you? Herrera. Emery Moorhead. Loping back up. That's David Stalls that made the tackle.
You got to play all 43 of the Cowboys. You mentioned Bobby Lane. He's over in Lubbock watching this today, and he's not feeling real good right now, Robert, isn't he? And I just wonder what he thinks about the young quarterbacks here for the Giants trying to work against a tremendously good defensive team. Bobby Lane was something special in this league for quarterbacks, as far as I'm concerned, Pat.
He certainly was. Here's Pisarcik, who the Giants hope might be something special. It's Bobby Hammond that got the ball, breaks the tackle, stays on his feet, and goes out of bounds. There's a flag back in the area where Pisarcik is struggling to get back to his feet.
Harvey
Goldstein
Martin,
did,
huh?
That's what... Harvey Martin is the guy that laid the hammer down on Pisarcik.
Let's see if the right side of your screen becomes blurred, because that's where Harvey's coming from. From the left side, pardon me. Ball was already delivered, and they're going to walk it off. Automatic first down. And the intensity that Martin shows you is what you've got to have to play defense. If you don't like to do that, you better play tennis or something else.
There it is. Crowd doesn't care for that call. 49 seconds left on the scoreboard clock. Just checking out what would happen. Pisarcik was very slow getting up. Randy Dean is the other Giant quarterback, and I don't know if he's even on the active list for this contest. Goldstein is gone. Again, it's Harvey Martin. What's he up to? He jumped up and had lots of words to say to Gordon Gravel.
He said, "Gravel, you're holding me, and I still got him, and take that." All right, to the right of your screen, they're stunning up the middle, Pugh and Randy White. He just came right through the tackle's block. If anybody watched last week, it was Harvey Martin that turned on that defense in the third period that turned off the Vikings.
And as soon as he went down, Harvey Martin jumped right up and jumped in the face of Gordon Gravel. Harvey Banks Martin. The Giants have taken a timeout now. That's why the trainers and group are out there with liquid refreshment.
Harvey's that nice, pleasant guy that we see before a game that puts on those headphones and sits in his locker listening to some good music just to get him toned down.
Remember, we asked him what kind of music he listened to. And he said, "Just something to relax me." Sarcik has been over for a visit with John McVay and now comes back. The score is Dallas 31, the Giants 7. Now we have 44 seconds left before the half.
You know, I said if you don't like to get hit, maybe I'll take up a game like tennis. And I'm just thinking of your friend Trabert. Trabert's a lot like Harvey Barton when you really get down to it.
He loves America.
That's right.
Willie Spencer comes out of the backfield as one of the backs. Ball is underthrown, intended for Ed Marshall, and Pisarcik didn't get it there. Again, the heat was on from Harvey.
You see what Harvey Martin has done to the Dallas defense, though. He's made a cause out of this, even though they've got the scoreboard on their side. It's now a cause now to, all right, they're doing something to us that's not right. Let's show them that we mean business. He's taken two or three people to the inside so that Randy White could come to the outside. Giants didn't block that badly, though.
Pisarcik had time then. They used 4 seconds. This last 2 minutes has been an eternity. It is third down now. Pisarcik drops. Harvey Martin almost got him again. Did put a shot on Pisarcik. A flag is down as Pisarcik took a real hit from Harvey Martin in the middle of the back.
I tell you, Gravel is making good contact, but he just can't stop the locomotive.
Holding is the preliminary indication. Here's Hardy.
Watch this. And Gravel makes good contact. He's about 258. Look at this. Harvey just goes ahead and runs through it.
Penalty is declined, so it'll be fourth down, Giants. Line of scrimmage is back up at about the 47, but the ball is back at the 37. Fourth and 20. Tony Hill is back with Butch Johnson for Dallas. Dave Jennings, the Giant punter. Dallas still has two timeouts left, by the way. Fair catch.
Illegal receiver down under the kick.
Mm-hmm.
Going to make Jennings kick it again, I suppose.
Johnson made the fair catch. And I imagine that.
Tell me, Dave Jennings is going to be a pretty good sportscaster. He's doing some radio up in New Haven.
He always does luck before the game.
I said, you just kick it. He can kick it, too.
We're walking around the lobby of the hotel this morning, and somebody said to Dave Jennings, how come all kickers are strange? And he pointed at me and said, ask him.
It runs in the family, huh?
Oh, automatic first down.
Illegal cut block. That means they tried to keep that outside receiver from getting down.
Violation was by Benny Barnes, number 31, so it's a Giant first down.
Man, this crowd's angry today. I feel like I'm in Rome about 2,000 years ago.
I hope it wasn't this hot. First and 10, Pisarcik drops. The double team is on Harvey Martin this time. It's picked off by Aaron Kyle. He gets back around to the outside. Robinson is the guy who made the tackle, and the Cowboys will gain possession.
Pisarcik goes back and sets up again. The young quarterback can't see the underneath people. This is sort of a prevent defense probably at this stage in the first half. And this young man runs the 40, by the way, in 4-5 out of Wyoming. Going to be one of the great cornerbacks around, believe me.
15 seconds left on that scoreboard clock before the half. And, of course, it won't start now on this change of possession until the ball is snapped. The Cowboys still have two timeouts. If I know Mr. Landry, they'll just run it out now. Brinson. That's what they're going to do.
Important thing to keep in mind, though, Pat. There was no complacency or smugness by the Cowboys going in. They wanted to play a tough football.
Well, they played a tough first half. They've looked just awesome. Both on offense and defense, they lead the Giants at the half, 31-7.
There's 85 feet between you and the ground, and there's enough juice at your fingertips to light up the county. But now comes Miller time. Time to head for the best tasting beer you can find. America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
When it's time to relax, Miller stands clear.
Beer after beer, if you got the time, we got the beer. Miller beer.
Announcing the new Firestone steel-belted radio 721 with 5 million miles of development testing behind it. Testing that tears at tires. Testing that scorches them with the heat of high speeds. Testing that plows them through a flood of salt water. That pounds and punishes them from sunup to sundown. Testing that tortures out the secrets, like the performance of our new 721 tire cord with 10 strands of steel where we had 5 before. The strongest steel cord we ever made for car tires. Tough testing proved this new 721 radio. But remember, the safety of even a tough tire also depends on you. Be careful where and how you drive. Don't overload. Check air pressure. Check wear. Check your Firestone dealer for the new 721. It's Firestone's finest radio ever.
Radar is wounded and Hawkeye is in trouble.
The hell with you?
Were you nuts?
Where's your decency, man?
Gee, you have a marvelous effect on people.
Then Julie runs into an older man.
I'm really sorry about your car.
Oh, don't worry. I always wanted a shorter car.
Yesterday it was Dr. Curran.
Yesterday I wasn't in love with him.
Tuesday at 9, 8 Central.
Next Saturday, the CBS Sports Spectacular presents the premiere of the World's Strongest Men competition, an exciting decathlon event featuring unique tests of strength. Live coverage of the Cup from Belmont Park and highlights of the Super Bowl of Motocross. That's next Saturday at 4:30.
Let me update that one remaining race in baseball. Eastern Division American League, Yankees lead Toronto 11-0. The game is in the eighth inning, the first of two. Boston ahead of Detroit 7-2, and Baltimore up on Cleveland 3-0. They are in the fourth inning in that Baltimore game. New York today lost the right to bid for the 1984 Olympic Games to the city of Los Angeles. The United States Olympic Committee voting 55-39 in favor of Los Angeles. The International Committee will make its decision next year, and of course, if no other city bids against Los Angeles, then LA automatically gets the game. Let's check now around the National Football League. Again last night, Minnesota had a scare, 9-3. They beat Tampa Bay. Washington and Atlanta, 10 minutes to go in this game right now. The Falcons have just kicked their second field goal. They trail the Redskins 10-6. Detroit and New Orleans still in the third quarter, and the Lions are ahead in that one 23-14. Baltimore and the New York Jets. The Jets trying to rally with a touchdown and a safety. Still behind the Colts 20-11 now in the fourth quarter. Seattle and Cincinnati. Cincinnati had been ahead 28-0. Then it was 28-20. Now it is 35-20. Seattle loses, but they're exciting, aren't they? Chicago and St. Louis. Just underway in the second half. St. Louis leads, and wait until you see the catch that J.V. Kane made for a Cardinal touchdown in that game. And of course, the contest you're watching at the half, the Dallas Cowboys, with just too much talent and too much experience, lead the Giants 31-7. Houston and Green Bay, this has been seesawing throughout the afternoon, tied at 10 in the third quarter. San Diego and Kansas City right now, James Harris is playing at quarterback, and it is 16-7, the Chargers with the lead. And Phyllis, quickly, a couple of baseball updates, 5-4, Cleveland now ahead of Baltimore, and that game is in the fifth inning, so that could be a big one for the Yankees and the Red Sox. And how about a music piece?
Take a breath. Boy, you do that really well. I'll take a breath for you. Well, you know, Brent, it seemed like just yesterday that Don Shula and Bob Greasy led the Dolphins to two straight Super Bowl triumphs. But the coin has turned. They've looked beneath the surface and brushed the film away. 1976 was another world for Miami, Don Shula's first losing world. And now Greasy, who's had his share of misfortunes, is wearing glasses. They both hope that coin will again turn their way for the Dolphins, and that all things truly run in cycles, as sung by Frank Sinatra.
So I'm down, and so I'm out, but so are many others. So I feel like trying to hide my head 'neath these covers. Life is like the seasons. After winter comes the spring. So I'll keep this smile a while and see what tomorrow brings. I've been told and I believe that life is meant for living. And even when my chips are low, there's still some left for giving. I've been many places, maybe not as far as you. So I think I'll stay a while and see if some dreams come true. There isn't much that I have learned through all my foolish years, except that life keeps running in cycles. First there's laughter, then those tears. You know, it's almost funny, but things can't get worse than now. So I'll keep on trying to sing, but please, just don't ask me now.
And, of course, Miami playing San Francisco. That'll get underway in about 20 minutes. A Washington rally was just choked off by an Atlanta interception. Highlights of that game coming up as the NFL Today continues on CBS right after these messages from your local stations.
Terror behind bars drives Yvette Mimeo to a desperate act in the movie Jackson County Jail, Wednesday on CBS.
23-16 right now, a safety for New Orleans. They still trail the Lions. This is Atlanta, Washington. Here is Kilmer going to Frank Grant down to the 6-yard line. Early in this contest in RFK Stadium, Mark Mosley kicked a 26-yard field goal. 3-0, the Redskins were in front. Now here's a play that might have turned the game completely around. Could have been a Redskin route. Watch Kilmer. Scrambles around. He's got Fugit. Fugit spots Riggins. There's the old sandlot pitch. Looks like a touchdown, but a holding penalty brings it back. Does not count. Now watch the pressure that Atlanta applies on Billy Kilmer. I'll tell you, this Atlanta defense looks pretty good here the first couple weeks of the season. Scott Hunter, who has replaced the injured Bartkowski at quarterback, wants Alfred Jenkins at the 11-yard line. Then the Redskins held. So it was Mickemeyer kicking a 23-yard field goal. This tied it at 3. Now the Redskins drive for the lead. Kilmer wants Taylor. Spots him over the middle. He gets to the 8-yard line. Now he wants his running back. Thomas, 22. Easy touchdown against the linebacker, so they got about 8 minutes to go in that game. It was 10-6, Atlanta trailing. Irv?
Brent, I'm listening to the Detroit-New Orleans game right now, and of course, Detroit leads that game at the Silverdome by a score of 23-16, and New Orleans has the ball at midfield right now, but Greg Landry in the first half gets things started early through the air as he hits Ray Jarvis on a 15-yard gain here. Goes back to the air once again, this time going to number 86, J.D. Hill, a great sprinter on the outside. Detroit draws first blood and leaves 7-0. Detroit 2nd-and-18 this time in Detroit on the 38-yard line. Landry feeling great pressure is hit from behind by Bobby Pollard. New Orleans recovers the ball, setting up a scoring opportunity by Chuck Muncy. Muncy this time going out on a run option pass, decides to pull the ball down and goes the whole route 32 yards. He legs it in for a score and ties it 7-7.
punt coming up this time. Detroit from their own end zone. Summers tries to get the ball away, but Tommy Myers of New Orleans blocks it. The ball's recovered in the end zone by New Orleans, and the Saints take a lead temporarily, 14-7. Detroit is not dismayed by that play. Landry comes right back, this time hitting Charlie Sanders for a touchdown. And on that play, Charlie Sanders became the all-time Detroit line receiver. 14-17 at that point, Detroit ahead. And then this time, Horace King goes over, takes a temporary lead for the Lions. The Lions still lead it in the fourth quarter by a score of 23-16.
Irv, while you were doing that highlight package, I see that Billy Kilmer has the Redskins on the move in the fourth quarter in that game. But let me show you a couple of plays now from St. Louis and Chicago. Cardinals in white. Here is Hart. Wants Harris on the sideline. Now, watch this next catch. It is the play of the day, without a doubt. J.V. Kane, how in the world does he pull this one in? Hart up high, goes Kane, one hand he's got the ball, pulls it down, touchdown for St. Louis. It is 13-3. Irv, that was some catch. How about the Dallas Giants game?
Great catch. Of course, the one thing the New York Giants could not do is turn the ball over, and they did it. Of course, the Dallas Cowboys lead at halftime by a commanding 31-7 score. Jerry Goldstein, early in the game, goes to the air and doesn't see D.D. Lewis, a linebacker here, as Lewis picks the ball off here, bringing the ball back inside the 10-yard line, setting up a Dallas Cowboys scoring opportunity. Third and two on the Giant 2-yard line. Roger Staubach runs a quarterback draw. He bulls in for a touchdown. Dallas leads 7-0. Dallas again this time, third and four on the Giant 10. Staubach goes to Preston Pearson. Score, Dallas 14, Giants nothing. Dallas second and seven this time on a Giant 43-yard line. Roger Staubach goes to Tony Dorsett. And look at this young man run. He's finally knocked down here, but a couple of things happen. Kelly and Carson were both knocked out of the game, and there's a young linebacker, Carson, going out of the ball game. Dallas third and 12 on a Giant 32. Staubach goes to Drew Pearson, takes the ball down to the 1-foot line. Doug Dennison does the rest, goes over, 21-0. Dallas, Giants this time, TD run by Tony Dorsett, his first touchdown as a pro, and Dallas leads 28-0. He's pretty happy about that. Second and 21 on the Dallas 1-yard line. Willie Sprincher goes in for a score, but Dallas has a commanding lead, 31-7 at halftime, Brent.
Irvo, you were looking at Dallas and the Giants. Atlanta hell, Washington. Still in the fourth quarter, 10-6. Redskins clinging to that lead. Again in baseball, Yankees routing Toronto in game one. Boston ahead of Detroit, 9-2 in the sixth. Cleveland ahead of Baltimore, 5-4. That game is in the sixth. The NFL today will continue on CBS in just a moment.
Want to cut your fuel bills? Whether your house is new or old, put insulation everywhere. It can save you money. Your attic. You need a 6 to 12 inch blanket of pink Owens Corning fiberglass. Walls. Full insulation. Unheated crawl space. Insulate below the floor. Live where it's cold. Insulate basement walls. See your Owens Corning fiberglass supplier to learn all about insulation. Insulation is cheaper than oil.
Ever get the feeling that you wanted to cut out?
Go home, Mustang.
Mustang.
Let a Mustang take you away, far away from an ordinary day.
Mustang.
With staggered shocks and front disc brakes, the 78 Ford Mustang 2 Ghia.
Go Mustang.
So cut out. Go Mustang. A better idea from Ford.
This is my team, the Chicago Bears. Hello, I'm Johnny Musso, and I'd like to show you Chicago. Carl Sandburg, the poet, calls Chicago the city of big shoulders. That's because it carries so much of the trade and commerce of this country. It's where trucks and trains and ships pass through on their way to all of America. It's tall buildings on the lakefront, Old Town, Rush Street, and the Magnificent Mile. And it's people, good-natured, hard-working people, people who work in our United Way, for the Boys Clubs, YMCA, Travelers Aid, and many other agencies funded by our United Way. They take pride in the Bears, in our town, in our United Way. You see, Chicago has more than big shoulders. It has a big heart. On behalf of all our volunteers, we'd like to say, thanks to you, it works for all of us, the United Way.
It's Dallas 31, the Giants 7. About ready to start the second half of the play. Preceding announcement was brought to you as a public service by the National Football League.
If anything, Patrick, it's hotter than it was. Maybe it's just beginning to get through to the bones. We understand some of the Giants couldn't go in the dressing room because it was so air-conditioned that they were afraid of going in and coming back out again.
Giants huddling around Coach John McVay. They're down 31-7.
Cowboys ran 44 offensive plays in the first half. They only ran 68 the whole game against the Vikings, so you can see they've had their hands on that hog bladder a lot.
And you can consider the 68 included a part of an overtime period. This is Pat Summerall with Tom Brookshire, and it is hot, hot, hot. Temperature when the game began was 93 degrees up here.
You know, we talked about the young quarterbacks having trouble, but last week, Fran Tarkington had three interceptions, intentionally grounded twice, was sacked four times. So the great quarterback, or perhaps the biggest one we know about, had problems with this Dallas defense, too.
Here is Joe Dinello's kickoff. Butch Johnson and Larry Brinson deep. Dinello catches it nicely. It'll be Brinson. And Butch runs over and says, Larry, don't you dare come out of there. The Cowboys will take over at their own 20-yard line. Roger Staubach, I believe, will still be the quarterback. Yes, here he comes.
Again, the problem is you don't want to tone down your team and lose the edge, so the Cowboys will still keep the heat on and play it like this is the new game. And it's not
hard to keep the heat on today. Staubach comes into the huddle. The Cowboys had 246 total yards in the first half. The Giants had 86, first and 10 at their own 20. Staubach, Newhouse, Preston Pearson, the other running back. Drew Pearson comes in motion, and Preston gets the call. Tries to cut back inside and comes back to the outside. Picks up a few. Knocked out of bounds by Bill Bryan. And like John Mendenhall got up rather slowly.
I think Burton Lawless is in at the left guard, so Scott... No, Scott is in, too, so Rafferty's the one that's getting a breather right now.
Burton Lawless is the right guard and the right tackle in the place of Pat Donovan is rookie Andy Frederick, who's about 6'6 and 260. They just got such a wealth of talent. Ralph Neely still playing. Staubach outside. Pearson. That's Preston. Jim Steinke right up there with him to make the tackle. Cowboys just totally dominated the first half. They lead 31-7. Touchdowns by Dennison, by Staubach. That was the first one, by Dorsett. And giant touchdown by Willie Spencer on a short burst.
Remember, Roger was always hovering last year before the broken finger around 60-something percent, and he was at that coming in, and he's 15 for 20 for 177 yards, and this is just opening the second half.
And this is third down right now, and three for Dallas. Looks back at Pearson and then rolls out and throws back across the field. Pearson dropped it. Ray Rhodes was close, but Pearson had the first down yardage and more. If he had been able to hang on. And now we'll see Danny White for the second time.
Just too easy a catch for Preston Pearson.
He's got to be diving in somebody's end zone.
Got to be holding on to him.
Danny White, of course, is the backup quarterback.
Pat, you see the little shoes he's kicking with? Of course, they're for the artificial surface, but they look like something you'd wear on a boat.
You mean like deck shoes?
Yeah, they're just little funny-looking little white shoes.
Danny White shoes.
Like the white shoes you kicked with for the Giants. Same one.
White in the direction of Bobby Hammond. At the 32, he starts wide to the right. Henderson missed him. Hammond gets a good return going. And still has a good return going. In fact, he's gone. Bobby Hammond. 68-yard punt return. Bobby Hammond, keeps doing things right.
And you know, he's such a surprise because he's 5'10", 170, and actually Bell was supposed to be the player to do most of this. But if we recall, three good kickoff returns early in the game against the Cowboys, and I'll tell you, he broke back against it and just flat got it on. I'm looking to see when the last time the punt was run back for a touchdown by the Giants.
It's been a long time. Joe Danilo will try for the extra point. Larry Mallory will hold. That makes it 31-13, and this could make it 31-14. Punt return of 68 yards by Bobby Hammond, who was cut by the Giants 2 years ago, went to New Orleans, was released by the Saints, came back to training camp this year, and wouldn't let him let him go this time. Bobby Hammond makes it closer, 31-14.
Você me conhece? Eu sou conhecido porque uso a cabeça no campo de futebol, mas também uso a cabeça quando viajo. Eu sempre levo comigo o cartão da American Express. Já usei em mais de 40 países. Ele é conhecido e respeitado em todo o mundo, até nos lugares onde eles falam línguas estranhas, como o inglês.
To apply for a card, look for this display wherever the card is welcomed.
The American Express card. Don't leave home without it.
We put Mobil 1 into this car and drove it 15,000 miles without an oil change. We then tested the oil and found that used Mobil 1 still protected the engine as well as new ordinary motor oil. Mobil 1, the oil that saves you gas, saves you oil changes.
Joe Danilo will kick off for the Giants. Own 35. There's some discussion going on right now. Looks like the Giants might have lost that kicking tee, and they're borrowing one from Dallas.
Rondé Colbert ran a punt back against New Orleans in 75, so it's been two seasons since we've seen one broken by the Giants.
Joe Danilo gets it teed up. Some of our monitors have been felled by the heat, so if we start talking about something that you're not seeing, I hope you just bear with us. Danilo to kick off. It's Brinson and Johnson back. Brinson, Johnson again says, let's start at the 20. It'll be first down, Dallas. At that point, Roger Staubach comes back on the field. Don't forget about the CBS Sports Spectacular, the world's strongest men competition, the Cup, the Super Bowl of motocross, all that coming up next Saturday at 4:30 Eastern Time. Participants in that strongest men, by the way, are John Cole, Mike Dayton, Bob Young of the St. Louis Cardinals, George Friend, Ken Patera, who's the brother of the coach of the Seattle Seahawks. They're going to be lifting a big, heavy barrel next week. Newhouse takes the forward handoff. He breaks into the clear. Flag is down as Robert Newhouse gets out close to the 40, out of bounds at the 38. Ernie Stotner very upset, as is Gil Brandt, over in front of the Dallas bench after that long run by Newhouse, and it looks like Gordon McCarter and group are going to call it back.
Tell you, Mallory really put Newhouse out of bounds, though, in rough style. He collared him, knocked him out. Watch the block to the top right of your screen. There's the block that sprung him. Now watch Mallory come over and really do a job on Newhouse. Super place for the defensive guy to get even.
I believe it was a clipping call against Golden Richards. The violation that nullified that run.
I thought it was the preamble to the Constitution. I never heard so much description. Does make it a first down, doesn't it?
Ball is on the 20. We're just into the opening minutes of the third quarter. Dallas 31, the Giants 14. First and 10. Staubach on a reverse to Billy Joe Dupree. Got a good block out in front. Billy Joe rumbles up for about seven. Taken out of bounds by Rick Dvorak.
As we've tried to say to you, a team that's heading for a Super Bowl, led by a quarterback like number 12, is not going to be able to turn it off. They are using plays. The tight end around is what you just saw. So they're playing this half just like they started out dead even. That's probably what Landry's philosophy was. Fellas, it's 0-0. Go out and play another good half.
Second situation now, second down. Billy Joe Dupree got 7 yards on that end around, so it's second and three. Comes Pearson in motion. Newhouse slips around to the outside. He got a couple of good blocks, breaks a couple of tackles. Gets a Dallas first down before he's knocked out of bounds by Dan Lloyd, I believe.
Giants are not giving anything away right now. They're putting bodies in front of blockers and runners. But they still nickel and dime you, the Cowboys do, and get the first. Watch this play now. Watch Newhouse as the Giants really string this out and play it tough. And watch Marion finally come over and make the tackle on this guy. Newhouse, another person that everybody except the Cowboys have been trying to cut for about 4 or 5 years, and he's pretty sturdy type.
He got a first down and then asked for a rest. Heads over to the bench, and Scott Laidlaw is the fullback now behind Staubach. First down, Dallas, ball at their own 32. Pitch back to Pearson. Archer had a piece of him, but Pearson squirms away. Gets another Dallas first down before Brian Kelly gets him out of bounds.
Archer gets up slow. Now, again, the second-year man from Colorado has a good shot. And watch him. He decides not to overrun the veteran back. Watch 77. The only thing he doesn't do is make the tackle, and he's mad about it. But I'll tell you, Pearson is slippery. He's like tackling an eel, isn't he?
Archer comes out now after that long chase, limping just a little bit. Now just bending over and trying to get his breath back, I think. Drew Pearson split wide to the right. A first down, Dallas. Ball at their own 44, and Rogers going to throw. And does. Wide open is Drew Pearson. He shakes to the outside a couple of times, down to the Giant 30. Stopped finally by Frank Marion. Drew Pearson.
Give Roger Staubach a big plus on this one. Watch his fake. Now Pearson's shaking. Watch the fake here. The linebackers stay a little too close, and now Pearson's speed has him down in that 20-yard area. Look how much room between the linebackers there and Pearson there. He's dangerous once he catches it. Marion makes a good tackle here. Good hustle still. Just give up yardage.
I can't figure out what happened to Drew Pearson. He is still bending over right where he caught it. And the Dallas trainers have come out to take a look at Drew. I think he's gotten cramps.
That could be what some of the players are going to have. If you're not taking a lot of salt in the first half, you could have a real problem with the legs in the second.
Flag is down.
Little clip action there. Number 66, it looks like Burton Lawless. Hit a Giant right in the back, and they threw the flag right on top of them both.
Again, a couple of the Giants on the far side of the field, very slow getting up. Marion and Brian Kelly.
Well, that Marion's been really hustling, too, number 51 back there. He's hurt.
Marion is 6'3 and 230. He's had 1 year of experience in the NFL. He's from Florida A&M. And there's the hit that he put on Doug Dennison.
Jack Gregory was the one that Lawless cut down from behind. There's Jack still standing.
Let's see if we can hear what Gordon McCarthy says.
Clipping number 66, offense, first down.
Burton Lawless, the guilty party.
Watch right to the right center of your screen. There it is. Delta State went all the way over, didn't he?
Yep. Talking to you about his soybean crop this morning.
Said he got the.
So, Brian Kelly walking away now and back to the huddle. It is hot.
The Ford in your future is coming October 7th. The new Ford Fairmont. A new wagon designed for today and the years ahead. The Fairmont wagon has excellent mileage ratings, but while it is trim and lean outside, Fairmont has almost 90% of the passenger space of most large wagons, and with its seat down, can swallow up all this cargo. Is Fairmont the Ford of your future? Test drive Fairmont October 7th. Find out for yourself. Fairmont, the newest better idea from the Wagon Master.
Time to trade in for TouchTune at your Magnavox dealer now. Trade in your old TV for any new Magnavox TouchTune color television and save big. Just in time for football season. And just for touching any TouchTune television, you'll be handed free the official 1977 NFL record manual. Choose from a wide range of prices and styles during trade-in for TouchTune time. Trade and save at your Magnavox dealer now.
Hawkeye hits rock bottom as Radar is wounded in action on MASH, Tuesday at 9, 8 Central and Mountain.
That's Frank Marion down on the Giant bench. He's really been hustling.
Lord. Carson's already gone. The first half, we saw Harry Carson go, so Lloyd is in there, number 54 at middle.
First down for the Cowboys. Ball at the Giant 45. Staubach to the outside to Dennison. Actually, look at that defense now. They've got Lloyd. They've got Brian Kelly. And they got an extra defensive back.
I think Danny White's the quarterback now, too. So we're going to get to see the
right.
young is. Man from the WFL out of Arizona State.
Who's a fine athlete. Look at this. Seattle got rolling, didn't they?
Yeah.
42-20.
Bengals have a lot of people, don't they?
Cincinnati picked by a lot of people to win all the marbles. Struggled last week against Cleveland, however. Danny White with the forward handoff to Laidlaw. Scott Laidlaw rumbles down inside the 25 to the 23-yard line. Stopped by Dan Lloyd.
Now, there are going to be some people say, boy, they're really trying to lay it on. But watch this little move, a little shuttle inside by Danny White. Remember, White hasn't done anything except punt twice. So he's going to try to work on whatever he thinks people want to see him do in the Dallas uniform. So it's very hard to turn off a team that has got these kind of people waiting to play.
Brian Kelly comes out, and now Brad Van Pelt has gone back in with his right arm heavily bandaged. Third down, Cowboys. Danny White, ball batted down.
By Lloyd.
By Dan Lloyd, the linebacker.
Pat, he started to get down into a lineman stance and come, and then it was so hot he just said to heck with it. He just came from the up stance, came right in and blocked it. Good play by Lloyd. Boy, this is when you find out where your soul is when you're having to play today.
20-12, that's the final score. Baltimore over the Jets. Brian Kelly is back in the game now as Efren Herrera. We'll try a 41-yard field goal with number 41 holding. Got plenty of distance. It is good. Cowboys 34, Giants 14. Herrera from 41 yards away makes it Dallas 34, Giants 14. 11:23 left third period.
Where does your money go after you put it in your bank? Well, some of it's right here, building your neighborhood, construction loans and home mortgages, but also with municipal bonding, money for your public parks, and money for your schools. Today, America's banks have over $80 billion invested in communities like yours. So if you believe in your community, there's no better place to put your money than your bank. America's bankers, helping you change things for the better.
To get ahead these days, you got to keep on your toes.
So I've got something to keep my competition flat-footed.
Sunoco's penny-pinching pump. It has 190, the gas that's made to sell below my regular, and 220, the gas that sells below my premium. So if your car runs on regular or premium, my pump can save you money on quality gas. Listen, if I don't want you to go right by me, I got to do right by you.
Sunoco's penny-pinching pump can fill up your tank for less. That's my way of being very friendly.
Efren Herrera.
He's trying to crush the ball.
Yeah. Checking out the pressure. Gordon Bell, and Emory Moorhead. Back deep for the Giants. Bobby Hammond getting a rest.
After 68-yard punt return, let's see if Bell can maybe turn the Giants on a little bit.
I see Hammond sitting down on the bench with a towel draped across his head. Try to shut out some of the heat. Line drive kick. I believe that's Willie Spencer. No, that's Beasley Reese. The Giants got him from Dallas. He wears glasses underneath that helmet.
Tell you one thing, he uses the helmet well. He took a head-on shot and made a pretty good return out, and the Giants don't have bad field position. 16-3. There's a shocker, but not really. Cardinals had too much offense to go around getting shut out like they did against Denver.
Speaks well for Denver, doesn't it?
Boy, it sure does.
First down, the Giants. Ball at their own 34. 11 minutes, 14 seconds left in the third period. Dallas still has most of the regulars on defense play. Doug Coter and Larry Zonka, running back. Well, there's a guy who looks like a different guy from what he did 4 or 5 years ago.
Tell you one thing, he's just beefed himself up. He's still a good-looking athlete. We're talking about Waters now. Watch him come through. He read his keys. He knows it's the run. Coter never goes down easily. But 41 made a tackle last week against Foreman, we thought was unusual, too, because it was such a clamp, such a firm one.
Okay. About a 4-yard loss. Coter on first down, so we'll make it second and 14. Pasarczyk, the quarterback. Like somebody moved in the middle of that Giant line. Thrown behind Coter.
Gregory might have made the premature move a little bit on the nose. Pasarczyk must have had a little bit of a staggered count. I thought he gave a little bit of a bob, but got away with it.
Check out who's playing defense for Dallas now. Randy White. There's Jerry Goldstein, sitting on the sideline on the Giant bench. Dallas defense is Ed Jones, Jethro Pugh, Randy White, and Harvey Martin. That's the front four.
It was Jethro. I'm sorry. I gave that to Gregory, and that's not fair because Gregory just came back on the active list, didn't he?
Offside.
He missed last week.
Defense, second down.
Benny Barnes, one of the cornerbacks. Mel Renfro had been one, but now he goes out along with Randy Hughes. Aaron Kyle on one corner, Benny Barnes the other. And the safety men are Harris and Waters.
They got the net out there now. They got the fast linebackers and five secondary men.
That is a final score. Washington beat Atlanta 10-6. Pasarczyk to throw. Across the middle to Zonka. First down for Larry Zonka. Bob Brunig made the tackle. And Tom, you know, you pointed it out to me before. We had not mentioned, I think, maybe only once in the entire first half, Bob Brunig.
And that means that defensive line is doing such a job that he just has been maintaining, right? Good play by Tucker, who is at 222 this year, but looks smaller. I think Bob Tucker might have a great year, but that's the first time they found him this afternoon.
I believe I said it was Zonka, didn't I? Whatever, it's first down. And the ball goes to Coter off the right side with not much doing. Houston, Green Bay in the fourth period, tied 10-10. Coter comes back. Joe Pasarczyk, quite a story. Some experience in Canada, but not in the NFL. In fact, the Giants began the season with no quarterback who had thrown a pass in NFL competition in the regular season.
That's bold.
Ridges. Second and nine situation as Coter comes in motion to the left. Pasarczyk throws inside Robinson. Spun down by Cliff Harris. But close to a Giant first down again.
Robinson had a touchdown pass against the Cowboys a year ago, and he makes a heck of a move, and only a great tackler might be able to say that. What's the tackle by Harris? I think we've told you before, of all the safety men I know around, the free safeties, I think number 43 is the best one.
It's a pretty good endorsement. 16-6 now. The Cardinals over the Bears. That's in the fourth quarter. Bobby Hammond and Larry Zonka now the running backs on first down for New York. Ball at the 42 and Hammond. Zonka. Left side. Good fake by Pasarczyk. Aaron Kyle had to come from the cornerback position to make the tackle.
Watch Van Horn's block on Randy White to the left. They cross block. Hill takes Randy White out. And Zonka hit the hole like the old Zonk. Wide open and full out. And that's one tackle that Cliff Harris won't want to make all afternoon.
You stop and start thinking about if the Giants do get seven here, that would make it 34-21. And we might be creating another game here. Bobby Hammond and Willie Spencer now the running backs. And this is Spencer. He broke a couple. Got down to the 25.
He is big. He broke the tackle that Randy White laid on him, but there's a final score. The Lions 23, New Orleans 19. Stram won the exhibition season, but as we found out, preseason games really aren't the same.
The Lions even their record at 1-1. New Orleans now 0-2. A couple of high-scoring affairs. They lost to Green Bay last week. Second down now. And seven. Ball to Dallas 25. Spencer goes in motion. Sarchik throws back to Hammond. Bobby Hammond gets inside the 20. Thomas Henderson, one of the tacklers.
Good play selection. Looks like a different offense than the Giants were running earlier. Maybe Joe's just now getting his feet down. Man in motion. Now he's the lead blocker, the toss back. And I'll tell you, the Hammond gets in there. He's a tough, short little running back. Good offensive series by the Giants. And the Dallas people are in there. The first team is still on the line of scrimmage.
You saw perhaps Pisarcik indicating to the bench that they only need about a foot for a first down, and so Zonka comes back in. It's third down. Spencer comes out.
Trying to keep fresh running backs, if at all possible, in there.
Pisarcik now has asked for a measurement, and they had to bring the chains all the way from the other side of the field.
That's pretty smart, even if he's a yard off either way, just to get a breather and talk to the bench.
His initial measurement was just about right. 7 minutes, 19 seconds left in the third period. The score is Dallas 34, the Giants 14. But the Giants are on the march. Tom Brookshire and Pat Summerall at Texas Stadium in Dallas.
You know, Pisarcik's a pretty good-sized guy, too. He's 6'4", 210 pounds. Big and bony. And running a pretty good offensive series right now.
He looks very, very confident at the moment. Look at this score. San Diego 16, Kansas City 7. That's the third period score.
The San Diegos have a lot of offensive people, I'll tell you that.
They got shut out by Oakland last week. Now, Pisarcik has called a timeout. There's something wrong with the lineup, he said. And he wants to come over and talk it over. Pisarcik has completed 5 out of 8 for 98 yards, including that 54-yarder to draft choice Johnny Perkins that set up the Giants' first touchdown. Right now, it's 34-14, Dallas over the Giants.
All across our land, people know our brand. You can trust AC.
Thanks, AC.
Spark plugs by AC. We'll help you smile throughout the miles. You can trust AC.
Thanks, AC.
Spark plugs by AC. So when you want to go, we're the name to know. You can trust AC.
Thanks, AC.
Spark plugs by AC. Firing spark plugs
thanks,
by AC.
Thanks, AC.
Maybe you're using Desinex, but to kill the fungus that causes the burning, cracking, and itching of athlete's foot, Aftate is better, much better. It's the killer. Aftate kills all major types of athlete's foot fungus and helps prevent reinfection. In fact, the medication in Aftate has been proven more effective in killing athlete's foot fungus than the medication in Desinex. Aftate is better, much better. It's the killer.
That looks like the team picture.
Yale, 1890, but they're legal. They're still on the bench, so to speak, but Dallas players have moved down into the shade as that sun goes by.
A third and about a foot for the Giants. Ball at the Dallas 19, 34-14 score. Zonka back close. That's Bobby Hammond. Got the first down for the Giants. Harvey Martin, Thomas Henderson, Randy White. But a first down Giants. They've hung in there.
I wonder what a Giant touchdown would do to the Dallas psyche right now. I wonder if that would be hard to sort of swallow when you figured you had them knocked out. Then they get the punt return. And now the Giants are on a legitimate door knocking job.
first and 10. Ball at the 17 now as Hammond comes in motion. Sarchik looks and throws, intended for Hammond, way overthrown, and wisely so because he was well covered. Mike Heckman and Aaron Kyle out close to him.
The freshest people in the stadium seem to be the pom-pom girls here.
But you notice they also are in the shade.
Looks different than where Tom Landry's walking, I'll tell you.
Yeah, look, he's still got on the coat.
Probably got thermal on under there.
The Yankees 15, Toronto nothing. That's a final score. And that red-hot American League.
That's baseball, huh?
Right. Didn't look like it. Sarchik fakes to Tunka. Now throws. Bob Tucker is open. Fumbles out of bounds. Tackled by Cliff Harris. But Bob Tucker got close to the first down.
Got to note that Drew Pearson did have the leg cramps. That's brought on by the tremendous heat. And the Giants linebacker Frank Marion's flat heat exhaustion. He's okay on the bench, but he's just out of gas. Good play by Tucker, huh?
He just sort of sifted out into the open as Sarchik found him.
He's averaged about 16 yards every time he's touched the ball in this league. Remember, the Eagles had him one time and never threw him a football. The Giants have made a habit of that.
He went from the Eagles to New England, and they didn't throw him the football. First and goal at the 6 for the Giants. They get inside the 5.
That's Zonka.
Zonka straight ahead.
Everybody talks about his speed being slower, but speed was never a prime asset. It's not how fast it went, it's how strong the darn thing was that came on those wheels.
Just under 5 minutes left to play in the third period. Today's attendance, by the way, 64,215, a sellout. Watching the Giants trying to come back. Doug Coker got in. Thomas Henderson had him wrapped up, but Doug Coker scores for the Giants, and John McVay.
Watch the block by Zonka on the outside. There's the one on Barnes that really allowed number 44 to get in there. And we've talked about this running back, Kodar, from out of Kentucky. He can find it. He's tough. He's a better inside runner than people think. And Zonka's still a heck of a blocker, too, isn't he?
Doug Coker scores to make it 34-20 now. Joe Dinello with Larry Mallory holding. Will try to make it 21. He does. With 4:42, things get a little bit more interesting, don't they? 4:42 left to play in the third period. It's 34-21. Tom Landry looking on and finding his team all in the shade.
I wonder what he's thinking, though. I know what Tom Landry's saying. He's saying, okay, now, let's go down and get a legitimate drive, either get 3 or get 7, and get this game over with. Don't fool around with this team.
Don't forget the Sports Spectacular. Super Bowl of motocross. This is next Saturday at 4:30 p.m. Eastern time. The Cup, which is the fifth running, a $250,000 purse. The race is the second of the fall Triple Crown handicap for three-year-olds and up.
What's the world's strongest? What are they lifting? A barrel of what?
Liquid shot, whatever that is. They'll start at 150 pounds.
You can't drink it, can you?
Can if you want to.
If you're strong.
That's going to be all next Saturday at 4:30 p.m. Eastern time on the CBS Sports Spectacular. Joe Dinello to kick off. Line drive in the direction of Brinson. Out of bounds. Kyle has to kick from the 30. Boy, on a hot day like this, you don't make too many friends by making them have to do that again.
With either team. This looks like a Hollywood review, you know. These dancing girls here are incredibly in good condition. Or well conditioned, I guess I should say.
Either way is right. 34-21, 4 minutes, 38 seconds.
Kicked that field goal last week, didn't he?
Yes.
At Dinello?
With 3 seconds to go. That 438 I mentioned just a minute ago is remaining in the third period. Seems like this has been an awfully long game. Sure not as long for us as it has been for the players. If you're wearing dark blue. Larry Brinson almost has it go over his head. Starts at the one. Wheels back up to about the 17. Bill Ellenbogen made the tackle. Let's check out another score.
Oh, good score to put over that nice lady. St. Louis 16, Chicago 13, and the Bears refuse to fall. I just wonder how St. Louis has been stopping Superman Peyton. There's no defense for that girl or Tom Landry's team. Got out of that without any problem.
Landry checking his notes now on the plays he'd like to call. The crowd getting a little uptight about the thing. 34-21 as the Giants have come back. Roger Staubach is back as the quarterback.
Green, 43.
Left tackle, I believe.
Yes, he did.
But Dallas moved a little bit. Number 71, Andy Frederick, the rookie.
I notice most of the starters are back in on offense. Fitzgerald's at center.
There's another starter.
Donovan's back in at right tackle. Neely's the only one getting a breather right now. Lawless is in there.
Tom Landry continues to shuttle plays by shuttling his wide receivers to call the plays and get them into Roger Staubach. Here's the violation.
False start, number 71, offense, first down.
Carelessness. Now the thing is, if Dallas has one big turnover, which they haven't had, the Giants jump back in this game deep in Dallas territory very quickly now.
That's right. First and 15. Ball at the Dallas 13. Newhouse and Dorsett, the running backs. It is Dorsett looking for some place to go and sifting around for perhaps a couple. John Mendenhall, the first man to hit him. Brad Van Pelt playing with that wrapped right arm. Came over to help.
I'm trying to think back to when I played in tremendous heat like this. And what I'm looking at, I forgot what I was going to say about how hot it was.
Second down, a 2-yard pickup by Dorsett makes it 13 to go. Roger Staubach's going to throw, and does. Golden Richards at the 29, taken out by Ernie Jones.
Just enough for the first down. They run those patterns for Ditka till they can do them in their sleep. This is from behind the defense. He'll go just deep enough and turn it out. The tackle is well made by Jones. It's a first down, and out of first and 15, they make the first.
Ernie Jones, number 31, is 6'3", 180, a 2-year man from the University of Miami. First down, Dallas. Ball at their own 29. They lead 34-21. Staubach. Newhouse took the forward handoff, but was wrapped up by Brian Kelly almost as soon as he got the ball.
Remember years ago, Brian Kelly was the ball boy for the Cowboys out in Thousand Oaks, wasn't he? Came from Dallas, and now he plays with the Giants.
That's Frank Marion, who, as Tom Brookshire told you before, just had too much heat and just collapsed.
Well, Frederick is playing the left tackle for Dallas. You can see Marion looking around and talking, so he's pretty much all right. But Neely just came down with the heat problem, too, and he might come back, but probably they'd like to rest him. He's had a couple of years.
Roger Staubach on second down. Fires, and the ball was not deflected, but Staubach was hit just as he let it go.
Jack Gregory, I believe, put the shot on him.
That's right.
He had 64 sacks. In 5 seasons, Gregory did. That's one of the outstanding totals in football, and we sort of lose sight of that sometimes.
That's right.
Roger is 17 of 24, Patrick, 214 yards. Last one, I guess, was his worst throw.
Third down situation now coming up for Dallas. Ball still at their own 29. Not much to cheer about for Dallas right now as they unveil the shotgun again. Stops up in pocket. Ball bounced off of Newhouse. He made the cut and had enough yardage for the first down. Couldn't hang on.
Van Pelt and Newhouse looked at one another like they wanted to bristle, and then they said, it's just too darn hot. The ball was not thrown as well as Rogers been throwing them earlier. That was sort of a tail winder, too.
So Danny White, excuse me, Tom.
Sorry. That score was up and down. San Francisco over Miami, 7-0 in the first period. That's got to be a shocking score.
Fourth and 10. Danny White standing back at his own 13. Bobby Hammond deep for the Giants. Bobby will get a chance. One heck of an effort by Benny Barnes, who missed him, got up, and got part of the tackle.
Dangerous little ball carrier, too. You better get him as often as you can. Barnes came by him and missed and then got up and made the tackle, Patrick. You're right.
He got an assist from Thomas Henderson, but the Giants now take over the football at about their own 32-yard line. 2 minutes and 45 seconds left in the third quarter. It is 34-21.
Have the Giants run a draw with Zonka yet at all? A draw would really get Harvey Martin and those people off his back.
Crowd starts to come alive now, encouraging the Cowboys. It's Coder protecting the football. Ed Jones under the bottom of that, and Coder got very little. Clock continues to run with 2 minutes 25 seconds left third period. Coder comes walking over to the sideline. Bobby Hammond has replaced him, and he's the setback with Zonka now. Bob Tucker still the tight end, tight to the right. Here is Zonka leaning straight ahead.
In a hurry, he gets there too. All right, you're looking at him. He's weighing about 228, and the knee is healthy. It still takes a load to work on him.
Harvey Martin and Bob Brunig combined to make the tackle on Zonka, but it'll be third down now and six. And Pisarcik in a situation where he has to almost definitely put it up. They're blitzing him, and they got it. A flag goes down. Cowboys brought everybody.
I saw Kyle and Hughes both coming, the secondary people, and I think Hughes went over the top of the pile to hit number nine.
Pisarcik getting up very, very slowly. Let's watch that blitz again.
Make believe you're the quarterback for just a moment. That's long enough.
Randy White was on the bottom of that, along with Randy Hughes. So Jennings, number 13, back to punt for the Giants. Butch Johnson standing at his own 35 for Dallas. They're coming again. Good punt by Jennings, and Johnson puts up the hand for fair catch at the 30.
It was some kick.
It really was.
He started out in the PPK, didn't he? Jennings, didn't he?
He was one of the winners. That was a 45-yard punt. And Dallas will take it over again. A minute 24 left third period. They still lead 34-21. Roger Staubach and receiver Drew Pearson in conversation right now as they come back to start this series. Pat Donovan, I see, is still at right tackle. Billy Joe Dupree, number 89, the tight end, goes to the left. Drew Pearson back as well. Dorsett and Newhouse, the setbacks. Pitch back to Newhouse. Billy Joe Dupree almost tackled Newhouse.
Well, I tell you, Brian Kelly came across number 55 early and really disturbed the play. And I'll tell you, the Giants are beginning to knock pretty hard. Remember, they did this against the Redskins. In the last 2 or 3 minutes, they came on strong. some problem there, but I'll tell you, the Giants caused some of it.
Newhouse almost knocked off his guard, Billy Joe Dupree coming back to block. There's Prasarczyk on the Giants bench. Butch Johnson split over to the right. Prasarczyk on the phone with the coaches up in the press box. Fake. Staubach. That's a tough catch, or a tough attempt at a catch. It was thrown behind him. Ernie Jones on the coverage.
Drew Pearson already had 6 for 97 yards. Again, you lose a little bit of the intensity when you have a team apparently out of it. And Roger has forced, I think, about the last 3 passes he's thrown.
That's what he's done so far today. Golden Richards has just brought the play in from Tom Landry. An extra tight end has also joined the offensive huddle for Dallas, Jay Salby. By Clyde Powers, but a well-thrown pass.
Boy, the rifle worked that time. Dupree is going down to run a square out. He's going to have solo coverage. And by the way, back in the pocket, Tony Dorsett came back and made a pretty good block on a rushing defense. Watch to the left of your screen. Watch number 33 come back inside and get a piece of him and allow Roger to throw it. JT Turner was the blockee, or the blocked.
The end of the third quarter with the score Dallas 34, the Giants 21. We now pause for a word from your local station.
Lenny loses his cool when his apartment catches fire in the riotous premiere of Busting Loose, Wednesday night on CBS.
The Shadow. Across the field at Texas Stadium. Of course, if you've never seen this place, there's a great huge hole in the roof.
On purpose.
Yeah. Miami 7, San Francisco 6, a first period score.
Patrick, I'm really proud of the Giant defense. And I'm not trying to belabor a point, but they could have just played out the second half.
That's right.
But they're not going to be humiliated. They have hit very well.
There's the hole in the top of the stadium that causes us those difficulties when the Shadows come across the field like they are this afternoon. First down, Cowboys. And the hand back to Dorsett. And Dorsett gets the ball knocked loose, but the whistle had blown. Brad Van Pelt on top of it. But Dorsett got about 5.
What does he accelerate?
Doesn't he? Gets in the hole about as fast as anybody I've ever seen. Here's Van Pelt trying to steal the football.
He's ripping it out of there.
Second and 5, 5-yard pickup by Tony Dorsett. Houston 16, Green Bay 10 now in the fourth period. Dorsett goes back into the shadows. Handoff straight ahead is Newhouse. Newhouse inside the 45 to about the 44, stopped by JT Turner.
Somebody threw his shoe out all the way back to where they'll huddle up. It's really getting a little bit nasty out there now. I thought somebody tackled Staubach almost before he made the handoff.
Laidlaw checks in. And who? Watch Roger.
Watch how fast now they're coming. Mindenhall has Roger when he's trying to get the handoff.
Newhouse lost his shoe and went out. Third and about a yard. Staubach overthrows Drew Pearson. And Danny White comes strolling onto the field as the Giant, as Newhouse taking care of the shoe problems in the shade.
I watched White before the game practicing on the corner kicks. Ditka was watching rather closely, and he can air mail it inside the 10-yard line, perhaps as well as any punter I've seen for a while. I don't get to see Ray Guy very often, but I'm saying he can really do it.
It's quite an art, and one that didn't used to be practiced very much, but in recent years, since they changed the rules about punt coverage, people are trying it more often. So Danny White standing at his 40. The Giants are coming to try to block it. They almost got it. They heard him that time. Jim Steinke is the guy who came charging across in front of Danny White and hurried that punt. Nevertheless, it goes out of bounds. Well, they're going to mark it at the 16, where the Giants will take over. They trail 34-21. We have 13 minutes and a half left to play in this game.
I drive a Ford pickup because my daddy told me they're built tough. Right, Daddy?
Right, and I bought a Ford pickup because my daddy told me they were built tough. Right, Daddy?
Yep, and I drive a Ford pickup because my daddy told me they were built tough. Right, Daddy?
That's right, yeah.
My daddy came to Texas in a covered wagon. I had to learn about Fords on my own. I'm a smart old bird, ain't I?
Of all Ford trucks registered over the last 12 years, 93 out of 100 are still on the job. Now try and forget the 10th largest life insurance company in America, Lincoln National Life. We're easy to remember.
Is it a fling or the real thing? Julie falls for an older man on the season premiere of One Day at a Time, Tuesday following MASH.
Thirteen and a half minutes left to play. The Giants with the football at their own 16. First and 10, Joe Pisarcik, the quarterback. Straight ahead is Zonka.
Pisarcik is now 6 for 10, Pat, for 109 yards, including the long bomberoo he threw to Perkins. After the original fumble snap, he hasn't played that badly.
He really hasn't. That long bomb was 54 yards, by the way. Moorhead comes out. Marshall is in and split wide to the left. Perkins is right. Second and 7 for Sarcik. Going for Perkins. Benny Barnes right with him.
Smart, too. Benny Barnes got in front of him, and Perkins would have had to run through 31 to get there. Very clever move. You can see that Perkins is reminding the official of it.
Perkins, the rookie from Abilene Christian. There's John McVay. In his second game, in his first full year as the head coach of the Giants.
He's 500, you know, 3-4 last year and 1-0 this year. He said, now I'm only 500 away from where we want to be.
Ron Mikolajczyk was number 62 on the Giants sideline. Ball's at the 19, third and 7. See if the Cowboys blitz. No. Zonka. Flag is down. Larry Cole made the tackle, but a flag is down, and a preliminary indication is holding against the Giants.
There was the draw we've been sort of looking for. Looked like maybe Tom Mullen had a problem with Too Tall Jones.
Cowboys probably will decline. At least the Giants think they will. Charlie Waters looking over to see what Tom Landry wants to do.
Holding, number 73, offense, declined, fourth down.
That'll make it fourth down. And Dave Jennings is in to punt for the Giants. Jennings standing on about the 8. Butch Johnson standing back on the 30. Jennings has done a good job punting. His last one was 45 yards.
Oh,
first try. Butch breaks one. Breaks two. to the 46. The flag is down again. Butch Johnson got inside Giant territory. Let's see what the discussion is about back here.
Butch takes it on the dead run, which is such an advantage for the return man because the first two or three people that come by just slide by. Jennings really kicked it.
Inadvertent, no foul.
No foul.
How do you call a no foul?
I never heard that call before.
Here's Butch running it back.
Dangerous punt returner is Butch Johnson.
It's the first one of those we've ever had called. For lack of something better to do, we will call no foul.
Illegal use of the flag, right? 34-21. 12 and a half minutes left to play in this contest. Cowboys look like they might run the Giants right out of this stadium in the early going in this game. The Giants have fought back. Still Staubach. This is Newhouse. Newhouse gets across about the 41. Where he's tripped up by Troy Archer.
And I'll tell you, Tony Dorsett came up and made a pretty good block for Newhouse. And that's going to be a proving point for Tony. He can carry it. Everybody knows that, including Roger, right? But that he can block is another thing we didn't know. He did a pretty good job on that play.
Something he really never had to do in college. He was the deep back in that eye almost always. And it's hard to block from back there.
Boy, if you're playing defense, though, and don't remember he's in there on the other side all the time.
It'll be second and six. Staubach overthrows, almost intercepted. Bill Bryant had a chance. A flag is down. It's going to be roughing the passer.
Mendenhall went by and gave Roger the assurance that, darn it, I was there. Watch to the right part of your screen and see if 64 beats Rafferty, 64. There he gets rid of it. Ball was gone. It's pretty hard to pull off your charge, though, and Mendenhall told him, I was there and took the shot, but I didn't really mean it.
There's John Mendenhall. In the American League East, Boston beat Detroit 12-5, so the Red Sox will remain 2.5 games behind the Yankees.
Four field goals, huh? You ever seen such baseball scores at that level?
The other one was 15-0. That was the Yankees over Toronto. That one was 12-5. Danny White, I believe, is now the quarterback. Yes, he is. And he is saying, I'm not quite sure what it is you want to do, coach. So let's go talk it over.
Let's see if we can sort of watch this conversation, see what transpires here.
That's Jim Myers with the headset on to Landry's right, entering in that conversation with Danny White and Landry.
Inside this new Firestone radial tire is an improved steel cord with 5 million miles of developmental testing. Where once we used 5 strands, we now use 10 strands of steel. 7 around 2, wrapped by 1. A cord construction so important, Firestone named the tire for it. 7-2-1. The new steel-belted radial 721. Now, from Firestone.
The Quintrix 2 color picture tube from Panasonic brings you a very lifelike picture. Because Quintrix 2 is our inline picture tube with an extra prefocus lens that concentrates and focuses the electron beam to bring you Panasonic's sharpest picture ever. So lifelike, you may even feel you're part of the picture. Quintrix 2, one more reason Panasonic is just slightly ahead of our time.
Roger Staubach and Drew Pearson. Buffalo 6, Denver 3. That's in the second period. Drew Pearson getting a little refreshment. San Francisco now 9-7 over the Miami Dolphins. Second period. Tony Dorsett shifts deep on first down for the Cowboys at the Giant 27. Ralph Neely back in, and he was one of the ones who jumped.
The defense moved and leaned, and then the offense moved and leaned. Let's see.
Against the Cowboys.
This could be the crucial defensive series for New York. If they don't sort of stop this and slow it off.
False start, number 73, offense, first down.
Still first down for Dallas. The ball now back at the 32-yard line. Thirty-four, twenty-one. Dallas over the Giants. Danny White gives to Tony Dorsett.
He is running up the back of the offensive blockers, and they are really hustling because they know he's there. Watch this. Barely a little false start, and he is up behind Rafferty in that game. And they're going to know that, so they're going to get out more quickly. And they know they don't have to do the cleanest job blocking. Just hit somebody and get out of the way.
Rams over the Eagles, 7-0, second quarter. Tony Dorsett. There'll be some motion in a minute. Tony Hill. Inside handoff to Newhouse, who squirms out of one. John Mendenhall. Finally rolling over with Newhouse. Watch this from the end zone.
Watch the pressure from the right part of your screen as the handoff takes place. You see that Mendenhall was right there, and Gregory is being dragged by Newhouse.
So it's a third down play coming up. Oakland nothing, Pittsburgh nothing. Second quarter. Danny White, the Dallas quarterback, on third down and five. He shuttles a fake. Throw is down the middle, intended for Golden Richards. Hit by Jim Stanky, and he knocked it loose.
Van Pelt was there too, bandaged arm and all. And I'll tell you that the Giants are hitting it a lick. They are hitting on defense. Here's the play over the middle. There's no more of the big openings down there that we saw in that first half. They've tightened it up.
And we'll have another look at number one right there, Efren Herrera. Look at this. San Diego in the fourth quarter over Kansas City, 23-7.
Pat, you watched Herrera warm up. Is he solid now after the miss in Minnesota?
He looks solid in the warm-up. He's already hit two. Not this one. The Giants block it. The Giants have the football. It was Al Dixon, I believe, that blocked it, and Troy Archer that fell on it.
Archer is always around it when it's loose. If he doesn't make it, at least he falls on it. And the block came up the middle.
There's Troy Archer, who's had one heck of an afternoon in spite of that score. 10:15 left to play.
Cold night, Bob. Did you put in the Presto antifreeze?
Presto, Presto. Who needs Presto?
Presto, Presto. You need Presto.
If your antifreeze is worn out or you don't have enough, you could be in trouble. So put in a fresh fill of Presto, too, to prevent corrosion and freeze-ups.
Presto, Presto. We need Presto. Presto, Presto.
Presto, Presto. You need Presto.
Europe's most successful new car in history comes to America. Introducing Fiesta, now imported from Germany by Ford. Fiesta, 0 to 50 in an average of 8.8 seconds. Road-gripping Michelin radial tires. The traction of front-wheel drive and excellent gasoline economy. Fiesta, Europe's most successful new car in history. Test drive one at your authorized Ford dealer now.
Look at down in the sun end of the field. A lot of people have just not been able to stand the heat and have gone home. And look at the fans working and the people who have stayed.
Looks like one of those card sections at a collegiate game.
And nobody knows what's going on. At the 40, the Giants take over. Blocked field goal by Dixon. Joe Posarczyk, the quarterback, and the time comes to throw. And he does. Wide open is Gary Shirk. A flag is down, and Shirk couldn't hang on. Big rush on Posarczyk by Harvey Martin. Gregory.
Shirk is limping coming off. He had the touchdown pass late against the Redskins. It's going to be what, holding against the New York Giants?
Looks like it. Here's Gary Shirk coming to the bench now. Al Dixon, the guy who blocked the field goal a minute ago, is the other backup tight end behind Bob Tucker.
Ball was well thrown.
Holding, number 71, offense, first down.
Gordon Gravel was holding Harvey Martin. There's Gary Shirk. That's the final score now. San Diego defeated Kansas City 23-7.
Randy White just came back into the lineup and Gregory went out, so Gregory did get some action today.
Gordon Bell and Willie Spencer, the running backs behind Posarczyk. Spencer. And another flag goes down. And Spencer took some shot. About four of the Cowboys converged around him, led by Benny Barnes.
Tell you what I like, though, was the way he put it down and decided to take that shot himself. There was no looking for his sidelines and all, and he is a big back. He's about 238 or 240. Clipping.
Against the Giants. Baltimore beat Cleveland 9-4 in the American League East in baseball. Thus, they remain two games behind the Yankees, who won earlier. And the Red Sox are 2.5 back. They won earlier.
Clipping and holding two plays in a row. The Giants had, 12 penalties against the Redskins a week ago. It's just impossible to win.
Clipping, number 25, offense, first down.
Gordon Bell was the player called for clipping. So the ball is all the way back to the 19-yard line. It'll be first down still, but 31 yards to go. A little bit over 10 minutes left to play. Dallas 34, the Giants 21. Larry Cole lined up right on the head of the center, Ralph Hill. Thrown behind Robinson. Posarczyk again under a heavy rush. A four-man rush put on by Randy White, Ed Jones, Larry Cole, and Harvey Martin.
Tell you, number nine has a live arm, though. Even the one he overthrew Perkins down here earlier when Barnes was had him well covered. He can cut it loose and rifle it. It is not a dead ball. He's got a lot of power in it.
He's got a little bit of a sidearm motion that would remind you of a little bit of Y.A. Tittle. And if he ever gets himself in that class, they've got something.
But he's got a head of hair that you won't believe.
Which, of course, Mr. Tittle was without. Second down. Posarczyk goes back. They're coming after him. Larry Cole in group. Picked off by Randy Hughes. Randy Hughes breaks a couple of tackles. Gets back to the 35. Emery Moorhead made the tackle. A pass that should not have been thrown.
Chance to run for a few yards. By the way, Posarczyk helped on that tackle with Moorhead. But he is mad at himself. Watch this. He's got a chance to, once he does beat the wave, and that's a little scary with Cole and Randy White after you and Harvey Martin. He could have probably picked up 7 or 8 yards. You're right, the throw wasn't necessary. Watch him come and get in on the tackle, though.
There's Joe Posarczyk. Dallas owns the football at the 35. Denver's going ahead of Buffalo now in the second period, 10-6. Danny White, Tony Dorsett, and Scott Laidlaw. The Dallas setbacks. Here's Dorsett.
We know he's not that big. We've heard how quick he is. Watch the cut at full speed here. And now he sees the flag, and you can forget it now. Oh, my goodness. How many draft choices? It sounds like a very cheap trade to me.
Sure does. That's one you'll see on the highlights a lot of times. Boy, is he quick.
Can't slow it down either. It's all flat out full speed.
Herrera, Charlie Waters holding. It is now 41-21. Is that worth another look? Watch him accelerate.
5'11", about 184 pounds. I'm telling you, the Dallas defensive people have told us he does this in practice, and sometimes they don't touch him, and they come back to the huddle sort of mumbling.
Sort of ironic. A few years ago, the Dallas Cowboys had another outstanding prospect, a great runner who wore that same number, Dwayne Thomas.
Dwayne Thomas, that's right. Well, this young man seems to have his head in the right place, and he's waited for his chance, and he'll still have to share some of the duties with Preston Pearson, I'll tell you that.
It's 41-21, and now they have something to cheer about. St. Louis beat the Chicago Bears 16-13, so that makes both those teams now 1-1. We'll have a chance next week to see the Cardinals against the Redskins.
Hey, that's right. That should be a good football game, and Tampa Bay has the job of playing the Dallas Cowboys, huh?
That doesn't look like it's going to be a very pleasant prospect, although the Tampa Bay Buccaneers played very well last night against Minnesota. The Vikings just beat them 9-3 in the event you didn't know that.
They've got seven All-Americans on that young defensive team, but the key word there is young. They are young.
And they're playing good defense. Here's Herrera. Emory Moorhead and Gordon Bell back in the sunlight for the Giants. 41-21 the score. It's going to be Bell at the one. Wedge comes to the right, and so does he. Guy Brown, the linebacker who made the tackle.
That's where all the linebackers pay their penance for the Cowboys. They can't play for 3 or 4 years, so they go on the special teams, and if they work out, they stay, and if they don't, some other team has a good linebacker around the league. It's quite a proving ground.
Right at the 20 is where Bell got it. You can almost feel the heat coming off that field all the way up here. And a lot of the crowd starting to leave, particularly where that sun is still looking them right in the face. 41-21 Dallas. 9:29 left to play. Joe Pisarcik, the Giant quarterback. Going to throw again. He's going to try to throw again. Gregory. Ed Jones made him step up into the pocket. And Jones and Gregory took him down.
But Pisarcik learned not to throw it when you're under heavy heat. Put it away. Remember, Gregory has been a great pass rusher in the past.
He was not dressed last week against Minnesota. This is Bill Gregory we're talking about. There's John McVay looking on with 9 minutes and 10 seconds left to play in this contest. Second down and 17 for Pisarcik. Lone setback for Zunka. Pisarcik fires. Waters was close. Kyle deflected it. That is Aaron Kyle.
Underneath, that's where those people seem to come out of the numbers and raise up against a rookie quarterback.
There's Jack Gregory.
Soybeans are in, huh? How do you get soybeans out?
You got to dig them up, I think.
I tell you, he's a good farmer. He's also been a real good football player in this league. And the Giants are getting identity again, though. It's going to be fun in New York, you know?
Third and 17. Tough spot for young Joe Pisarcik. Patterson flank Joe. Spread out. Throws to Gordon Bell. Bell gets away from a couple, gets out back to the original line of scrimmage before Benny Barnes.
For what little remained of the game, doomsday descended on the unfortunate Giant rookie Joe Pisarcik, and New York never again came close to mounting a scoring threat. The Dallas veterans rested on the bench and savored their accomplishment. 41 points and 444 yards total offense, while holding the Giants to 161 yards. merely 69 on the ground. But in the future, this total team effort by Dallas is more likely to be remembered as the day talented Tony Dorsett broke loose.
Roger Staubach led the Cowboys to two first-quarter touchdowns and completed nine straight passes as Dallas jumped ahead 28-0 in the second quarter. But the biggest crowd-pleaser was million-dollar rookie Tony Dorsett, who broke the ice to score his first two touchdowns as a pro.
Well, personally, I don't feel satisfied about the way I performed. You know, I think from a fan viewpoint, it was a good ball game. It was two touchdowns, and the second one coming when the game was sort of changing ties. The momentum sort of went to the Giants, and they were scoring. And at that time, people were sort of wondering what was going to happen. I broke that one, so that was a good point, good thing for the fans. But as far as I'm concerned, I had a mental breakdown. My blocking wasn't up to par. I missed an audible, so I dropped a pass. I still have a way to go, you know. I'm working on it. And I think just through playing experience, things will get better for me.
Dorsett is still a reserve in the Cowboy lineup, and he predicts if he becomes a starter, he has a chance for a 1,000-yard season. The Cowboys are now 2-0 and on top of the NFC Eastern Division. John Gross, The Texas News.